That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online as well at freetalklive.com. You can get interactive there, a variety of different ways to appreciate or to enjoy the show, including the newest one, which we'll tell you about, the new Free Talk Live listening app that is available. We'll let you know how to get that here in just a few moments. The we in studio tonight includes me, Ian.
Me, Tarrin.
And me, King Mark the First.
All right. Our toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. There apparently are some perverted people running around the city of Portland dangling sex devices from the power lines. Definitely
marital aids.
Okay, you can call them whatever you want. I'm trying not to use the word in the headline because that could be considered offensive to some of our radio stations. So we'll talk more about that because, Tarrin, both you and I actually brought this one in here tonight. That is usually an indicator that it's worth talking about.
Rubber phallic devices.
That's a good way to describe it. I presume they are rubber. They look rubbery from the photo that's included in this.
Marital aids.
Article from Boing Boing. But first,
only married people use those. Is that
the deal? First, we're going to go to the phones and to the fun because that's what we do here. We take your calls about whatever is on your mind, and we've got an update on Crom. You may recall Crom from Brazil. He was arrested along with three other people in Liberland. Now, Mark, what is Liberland before we bring Michael here on the line?
Liberland is a little piece of land between Croatia and Serbia that is not claimed by either country. Really, it wasn't claimed by either country. It was legally something called terra nullius, I think is what it's called. And so, well, what do you do with a piece of land that's not claimed by a country? You make your own country. So they did. The president, I'm doing my best. I'm sorry, Vit.
Didn't you get to meet him?
Vit Jedica. There you go. Whatever it is, he created a country, and they have really fleshed this out. They've got themselves a working constitution. They've agreed to the Geneva Convention. They've been recognized by certain sort of, including Free Talk Live organizations, including Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live has recognized the nation of Liberland, and what they're intending to do is create a place. We'll call it a nation. Create a nation that is liberty-oriented as opposed to the rest of them out there.
It's so, 3 square miles, the plot of land, basically in the swamp. Why anyone would want to be there is a good question, but you know it could be turned into something if enough investment was put into this thing.
Well, they want to be there because it's easier to create your own free place than it is to wrest from some organization calling itself the government.
Unfortunately,
a free place.
The Croatian government is not interested in letting them establish Liberland, and they have been arresting everyone who sets foot in there, including Crom. He went to court. Michael is with us. Actually calling from Florida. Michael, you're on Free Talk Live. You got an update on this case?
And it's an unfortunate update because they are throwing the book at our friend Crom in every way imaginable. Yesterday was his, we're calling it a show trial because it wasn't much of a trial as we understand it to be. They sentenced him to 58 days in a horrible prison. That's just under 2 months, and really, the really disappointing part is that his attorney was not allowed to offer any evidence of his innocence.
Wow!
And we have plenty of evidence. We have videos of his arrest. We have a map from the Croatian government itself showing that this is not Croatia. We even have a statement now from Croatia about Liberland, where they have stated that it is between Croatia and Serbia, and they do not claim the land even still, even after Liberland has claimed it. But nevertheless, they are still putting people away into jail without allowing them to even defend themselves.
It's just incredible. Now, you were in Florida. There were people, I presume, who were there for the trial today and witnessing this?
Unfortunately, my understanding is that in Croatia, you usually are able to attend a trial, but of course they are closing the doors and only letting the people on trial and our attorney in, which makes it very difficult for supporters to be there to record this, to cover.
Wow, so these are not public trials? This was not a public trial?
No, they're holding it in private, which I understand is unusual. I'm obviously not a Croatian legal expert, but by my understanding, that is unusual.
I don't quite understand how they even got around the whole jurisprudence thing. I mean, how do they even have jurisdiction here?
Well, the claim that is made in the media is that there's an agreement between Serbia and Croatia that as they are figuring out their border situation, Croatia is claiming that they have been given jurisdiction over this side of the Danube River, and that Serbia, where they both have claims for the same land, it has control over that land until they sort it out. The problem with this is that no one has ever been able to show us this agreement. We're asking for it repeatedly from the government. People who debate us online say this agreement exists. We say, okay, show it to us. Of course, no one has ever been able to produce this agreement.
And just to be clear, this is supposed to be an agreement between Croatia and Serbia?
Correct. And Croatia is claiming that A, this land belongs to Serbia. Of course, we know that Serbia states it's not their land anymore. It was historically at one point, and now they have taken away any claim from this land. They no longer want it, and they have stated so repeatedly.
And Serbia supports you guys in going there. Serbia's got no problem. Well, that's what
they haven't been making the arrests, but
there's a certain level of support there from Serbia. Go ahead.
Indeed, the local government has been very friendly and supportive when our people speak to them. The police have been supportive. There was even an incident where LSA members went into Liberland and were about to be arrested, and the Serbian police actually came across the river and said, "Leave these guys alone. They're not doing anything wrong." Nevertheless, the Croatian police still took our people into custody.
So even in that incident where the Serbian police were on the scene as well, Croatian police still made arrests?
Yeah, absolutely. And, it's gone so far. I mean, they're so severely cracking down on the Liberland movement that a member of European Parliament came to this area to see Liberland for himself in person, and he was carrying a diplomatic passport with some immunity against any sort of prosecution in any way. And they still saw his diplomatic passport, detained him for 4 hours.
Wow.
They had to let him go, but his assistant was arrested, who was traveling with him, and spent the night in jail and had to pay a ransom to get out. So
what has happened really with... Now, Crom was like the 20-something, close to 30th person arrested. What has happened with the other 20-something people? I mean, have they all been found guilty too? Are those trials still pending for some reason? Why was Crom's trial, the one that has gotten all the attention?
Well, there have been a few that have gotten attention, depending on where the person's from and their home country. Usually we get a lot of press. What it is that most of the people who get arrested do not want to spend time in this prison because it is bad. There are murderers there. There are very violent criminals. They put you in the same cell with them. There's very little sunlight. Some of our arrested members were denied food and water for almost 24-hour period despite repeated requests. So this is not a place that people want to be. So the LSA's policy is that if you want us to pay the ransom, we will take you out if you request it. Obviously, it's better if we stop paying our captors, but we can't really force people to stay in these kind of conditions.
So what you're saying is other people who have been arrested have paid the ransom, and so therefore they're not going to jail?
They are going to jail for a day or two, but even if they get longer sentences, we can pay to remove them instead. And with Crom, it's a very interesting situation because he was on house arrest for 8 days while they were awaiting his trial. And I believe he was even able to call into your show.
He did, actually. Michael, if you want to tell more of the story, hang on. We'll bring you back here in a moment. 855-450-FREE, the latest from Liberland with Crom going to prison. Croatian prison for something like 2 months because he went to Liberland. That's all he did. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. you certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com, SupernaturalSilver.com, and use the promo code SILVER2015 for 30% off of your entire order. And give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you may dial toll-free to join us here at 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about the latest from Liberland, where multiple people have been arrested, and now one of them, Crom, has gone to jail. He's in a Osijek prison, 68 days.
Osijek.
How's it?
Osijek.
Osijek. He's in Osijek prison and is going to be there for the next 2 months. We've got Michael on the line in Florida, who is going to continue to explain the situation. So, Michael, what you were saying was they basically had a private hearing. This was, you know, this is Croatia. The rules of all the Western world courts don't necessarily apply. You know, here in the United States, we're used to the idea of having a public trial. in this case. It was not a public trial.
They should apply because they are, you know, Croatia, I'll remind you, is now a part of the European Union. So there's a certain level of standards of human rights that's expected of Croatia.
Hmm.
So the treatment that our members have received in the last few months is absolutely shocking. There is an appeal process ongoing. Justice is very slow in Croatia. But we anticipate that the higher courts probably won't be able to get away with what these small local courts are doing to us. And with regard to Crom, something that is quite unique about him is that on the last day of his house arrest, he was given strict instructions to stay in Croatia, and they even held his passport. But he decided to do something interesting. He took a four-hour walk to the very place that he was originally arrested.
Really?
Where they're accused, which is in Liberland, and they claim it's Croatia. And he said to himself, okay, if I'm not allowed to leave Croatia and you're calling this Croatia, I'll just go to this spot. Let's see what happens. Unfortunately, they immediately arrested him.
Oh, no.
And he.
Now, hold on. Just to make it clear, my understanding of the story is he didn't cross into Liberland. He went to the line and sat down. Is that right?
That is not correct because there's multiple lines here. It's a circle, kind of. And the river is one part of the circle, and Croatia, where he's coming from, is the other side of the circle. So he passed into that circle of Liberland, went all the way to the end where we cross when we enter on the river from Serbia, right where he was arrested. But he didn't leave Liberland. He stayed in Liberland, which they were calling Croatia when they arrested him. And he said, okay, let's see what happens, because in previous arrests from the land from Croatia, they call this land Serbia, which is an obvious contradiction. And he wanted this contradiction to be right in the face of the judge, just to see if we can get some ruling on this of some kind, because we've had over 30 arrests and they won't decide on this contradiction. Unfortunately, they just ignored the contradiction, didn't allow us to present any evidence of this, and then basically a show trial said 58 days, too bad.
And that's where he is now. And did you say someone else was also sentenced?
Yes, we have another person who is currently, unfortunately, in jail. He went on the same day as Crom. Except he was representing the Liberland Red Cross. He has a bit of a first aid response background, and we have the president of Liberland established, because we are very serious, a national Red Cross society. And he was there to observe and to offer first aid to anybody, including Liberland citizens or Croatian citizens or even the police, if necessary. He did have symbols of the Red Cross, and they immediately arrested him as well. And he is sitting in jail right now, not only because he entered this land, but they have charged him with using the Red Cross symbol outside of the Geneva Conventions, which is a little bit shocking, just because...
Yeah, that sounds like a pretty big deal. That's a big charge.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you couldn't hope for much more, honestly.
So how long has he been sentenced for?
He's been sentenced for 10 days.
Wow.
And partially because he was using those symbols. They even, as I said, they threw the book at Crom. So even though he wasn't wearing the Red Cross T-shirt or using the flag, they found a photo of him where you could see the Red Cross symbol. So they've charged him with that and found him guilty without any defense from the attorney. So anything that they can do to basically intimidate us and to be harsh and keep us in prison for as long as possible, or make the fines as high as possible.
So had Crom been willing to pay the fine, would he not have had to go to jail?
As I said, you initially have to stay in jail for a little bit, but my understanding is you can exchange your time in prison for money, basically, and they will let you go.
Well, right. I mean, generally, when you're saying you're spending time in jail, you're spending time in pre-trial, right? So you get arrested, they hold you in the facility until the trial, and then, you know, if you get sentenced at that point, then you go back, or you can be sentenced to time served. At least that's how it works over here in the United States. A very interesting situation. We know that that's what Crom was going to do when he called the show. He explained to us that he was not going to pay any fines and that he would just go ahead and sit in this prison as long as was necessary because he was not going to bow down to the Croatian government's demands. And so kudos to him for taking that strong stance. It sounds like he's the first of many to actually do that. Others have gone ahead and paid the fines to get out, which means
you can certainly understand why they would.
I can absolutely understand why they would, but I also appreciate where Crom is coming from, trying to stick it to the man, because you don't want to reward these people for arresting these guys. I mean, this is just if everybody pays up when they get arrested for going to Liberland, then that's just a cash load for these Croatian guys.
Do you know if there's ever been such a thing as like a call flood or a large mailing to something international like this? Like, you know,
Good question.
Used to have the mail to jail. I wonder what their response. They probably never even seen that in another
country. Know, Michael? Do they let does a Croatian prison allow mail to prisoners?
I don't know for sure about mail. I do know that his girlfriend is unable to visit him, except for, they said, every 10 days, which, from my understanding, is very unusual. They're even trying to punish him in that sense and not allow him to have visitors.
Yeah, solitary.
He's supposed to be allowed to make phone calls. He hasn't been allowed. Our past prisoners have not been allowed to make phone calls. We haven't heard from him yet. We're desperate to hear about his situation.
Right.
He is black, and he has been treated with racism since he's been in Croatia. They have repeatedly referred to him, I won't say it on your airwaves, but as the N-word.
They know the N-word? Apparently.
They know it well, and they're using it very frequently towards him, which is just very disturbing.
I blame rap music.
And we're quite frankly concerned for his safety.
Yeah, I think you should be. I mean, these guys can do whatever they want, and they'll likely get away with it. And if it's as dangerous as a prison as you suggest, it could be could get to the point where they have prisoners attacking him. I mean, I don't know how crazy this is going to go, but it certainly could.
Sometimes these countries, the smaller ones, not the United States, sometimes countries will care about petitions. There's been some success with some countries getting pressure if enough people sign a petition. Has anything been tried like that?
I've seen some petitions, online, even the whitehouse.gov, which we all know how effective that is, a petition has been created. But something that they've been doing in Europe, which I would like to see expanded to all over the world, is that
Hold
they
that
have
thought,
been going...
Michael, if you want to explain, we'll bring it back. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here. This is Free Talk Live. The latest from Liberland continues.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. Keenevention.info. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us toll-free, 855-450-FREE. And you can also get on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Just send a contact request along, and we will approve that. You'll be good to go to call us on Skype from that point forward. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
And Next Issue. How about a 30-day trial at nextissue.com/FTL? What is Next Issue? It is the way to read magazines for the 21st century. I mean, magazines, you know, you look at them, they're kind of expensive, they're going out of style, but not in digital form. In digital form, you can get your favorite magazines with bonuses like interactive features, videos, and photos. We're talking about more magazines than you could possibly read. I've got 19 in my subscription list over at Next Issue. I just went down a list of like 100 plus magazines and clicked the ones that were the most interesting to me. And that's all that it took for me to sign up for all these. You can get Next Issue for as little as $10 per month. It's all the stories, the news, and the photos from the most relied upon sources. And it's good on your tablet or your smartphone. So iOS, Android devices, go to nextissue.com/FTL, get your free 30-day trial, and you can read up, way up, on all of your interests, nextissue.com/FTL. It's everything that's in the print editions on the same day they hit newsstands, plus all the bonuses that you can only get in electronic form. Cool stuff.
Does that mean that you can pay one price and read all these magazines, or do you buy
got
each magazine?
No. $10 a month, you get pretty much all the magazines you can subscribe to.
Wow.
It's incredible.
I wonder how they work that
basically
out.
Basically for the price of two magazines at the newsstand. If you want to get the weekly ones, it's $15 a month. So you for $10 a month, you get access to all the monthlies. And then for $15 a month, I think it's all the weeklies are included, so the newsweeks and things like
that. I'm still a little upset because I have been a Mad Magazine subscriber for 20 years, and I just stopped like 2 years ago. So I wonder if that's on there.
I'd have to check. I don't have the full list in front of me right now, but these are big-name magazines. People,
awesome.
Rolling Stone, Cosmo, ESPN, Sports Illustrated. I mean, just all over the map, different topics, different
Very
interests.
Cool.
Nextissue.com/FTL. Go get your 30-day trial for free right now. As we go back briefly to Michael, and we'll continue with more of your phone calls. Michael's been updating us on the situation in Liberland. He's actually calling from Florida. Michael, you were going to tell us something about Europe and a petitioning process.
Well, it's more than petitioning. We're actually showing up in person to the Croatian embassies to protest and to ask for answers of the embassy workers there. And we have seen some nice success so far from this. In Copenhagen, when we had someone from that country who was in jail, they protested for 5 days. They were able to basically close down the embassy for almost a week because of the protest, which basically brought a lot of attention to the cause in that country. We had protesters in London who went to the Croatian embassy there. They were able to actually speak with somebody on camera and ask, hey, why can't we go to this piece of land? To which he responded on camera, oh, you can absolutely go. He called it part of Croatia and said, oh, there's free access, even while people were sitting in jail for going there. This prompted a response for the first time from the Croatian government for them to actually put out a response because of this video and their embassy worker. So these are some small things that we have been doing that are kind of pushing us further in this movement. For people who are just listening right now, just sending emails to the Croatian embassy of your country, the more they hear from us from all over the place, the more they realize that people care about this issue.
That's what we've learned here doing the call floods you were referring to, Tarrin, is that if these government bureaucrats who are kidnapping our friends, our liberty-loving friends, even if we don't know these people, just kidnapping liberty-oriented folks, if they are let know by phone call, by email, that there are people out there who are paying attention and who don't appreciate what they're doing, that seems to encourage them to let those people go sooner and treat them a little bit better when they're in custody. That's been the experience we've had, at least up here in New Hampshire. Other people, like when a Damo has been arrested, Damo Freeman from copblock.org, in various different places, it's people calling the prison, people calling the court. That seems to make a difference. Now, Michael, just curious, before we let you go, you're calling from Florida. Have you had the opportunity yet to go to Liberland, to go and visit that area?
Unfortunately not. It is quite a while away from here. I do plan on hopefully going soon. We've had a lot of Americans go over. We have some there right now. We've even had some arrested, which is the ultimate vacation. But it's a very nice area. It's very beautiful. The LSA has rented 3 homes on the Serbian side just across from Liberland. We have 2 large villas, beautiful facilities, beds, full kitchens, camping grounds, and we are looking for people to volunteer. So if you're passionate about liberty, you can stay there for free. We will feed all volunteers for as long as they're helping us.
This sounds well-funded. I mean, thank goodness for whoever it is that's behind the Liberland Settlement Association. Where would you recommend people go? The Facebook group? Is that the best place to go? Or the Facebook page? Or what?
It is. Just look up Liberland Settlement Association. You'll find us on Facebook. You can join our group there. Also, just emailing us if you're interested in volunteering. It's simply info@liberlandsa.org.
Thanks, Michael, for your call tonight. Feel free to have anybody call in with further updates from Liberland. It's the best way for us to get the word on what's happening is to hear directly from you guys.
The news sources aren't going to cover this as thoroughly, and you guys are going to give us a more complete stories.
Thanks, Michael. Appreciate it.
I thank you for covering Liberland, and thank you for recognizing it.
It's our pleasure. Thanks for the call tonight.
We want to be state radio for Liberland.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, Skype in here. Username is lrn.fm. Let's go to James. He's in North Carolina. James, listening to Talk Radio 850 in Durham. Go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for taking my call. Sure. I'm curious, who's funding this movement?
I don't know. There's been a few. The Liberland, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've heard that there's some some mildly wealthy individuals in Europe that are funding it. I couldn't say anything more than
that. It's attracted a lot of attention. I mean, when Liberland was announced a few months ago, it got a huge level of press coverage internationally. There were quickly 300,000 to 500,000 applications like within the first month for citizenship from Liberland. So there's been an incredible outpouring of support and interest, and I would guess that it's not just a few people, but I imagine the funding is coming from quite a few people. But that's just a guess. I'm not involved in it.
It'd be interesting to see if we could get that guy to do some consulting and maybe do it a few places here in the United States. Maybe get some of Ted Turner's land out in Montana and start a new country.
I'm for it, but mostly what you got to do is when these situations arise, what they're trying to do is they're trying to get people to go there. So, I'd love to see something like that, a whole bunch of Liberlands all over, but they had a really unique opportunity with the terra nullius, this legal designation of this land being unclaimed. Ted Turner claims his land.
Null land, basically.
I would think you could talk Ted into giving up a few bison and a Ted Turner. Acres, maybe.
Here's what I'd suggest, James. It's not going to be the same here in the United States, but the Free State Project is probably the best option here, where liberty-oriented people are coming together physically to one place, and that place has been chosen to be New Hampshire. And we've got over 1,500 people who've moved here now. Over 1,700 actually are here in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. The three of us in the studio are early movers. We're looking to get 20,000 signed up over at freestateproject.org to pledge to make the move here and then to get active to work to achieve more liberty in our lifetime. But, the more secession movements we can see around the country, the better. I think that's another important idea. And there's actually news about Texas and their secession movement, which we can talk about here in a little bit. Anything else, James, you want to share tonight?
That would be Texas would be interesting. It's my understanding they're the only state in the union that joined the union by treaty. And in my mind, they should be able to renegotiate the treaty.
Yeah.
Everybody should be able to leave the union. Thanks for the call, James. I appreciate it.
I should, but
the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you can join, you should be able to exit. But what's going on in Texas? Looks like they are going, hitting the road and going on a speaking tour. The Texas Secession Movement looking to spread the idea, and I got to hand it to them. It's a great idea to go on a speaking tour for this. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And now we're extending our in-home trial to let you try Listen Clear risk-free for a full 45 days. With free shipping, we'll even give you free batteries for life. Call now, 1-800-956-9829. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your extended 45-day in-home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-956-9829. That's 1-800-956-9829. 1-800-956-9829.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Back now with more Free Talk Live. We got time for you to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can, of course, join us via Skype. It's Skype username lrn.fm. We have an app, and it's so
finally
new. It's so new that I have not yet even made the banner graphics. Like, I need to put up a banner on the site and probably need to add the app to the website as well. I haven't gotten to that yet. I got the news today that they are done. They're online. And you can find it in your favorite Apple or Android store. Search for LRN.FM. Searching for Free Talk Live is not working at this moment, but I'll see if I can get that fixed. It's an LRN.FM/Free Talk Live app. You can listen to both of the streams. In fact, you can listen to all of those streams because there's different bandwidths. So if you want to listen at a low bandwidth, you can do that, or mid bandwidth, or high bandwidth. So that's changeable within the app settings. And it's nice. It works. It's the first version. There's going to be a couple new additions. There's a few tweaks that I've asked them to make to it that they're going to add in, like a link to the program guide for LRN.FM. And right now, though, you can easily go and you can tune into the Free Talk Live live streams 24 hours a day and listen to LRN.FM with a new LRN.FM app available for both Android and iPhone. The best way to get it, I think, would probably be to go to either Android.lrn.fm or apple.lrn.fm. I made a couple of short links there. So Android or apple.lrn.fm, and that will take you straight to the entries in the appropriate stores and should make it easy for you to install them. At some point, I'll get banner graphics up and we'll put the links up. If you also go to the mobile site, maybe it's easier to go to the mobile site. Go to m.freetalklive.com. First two links on the mobile site are to the Android and the Apple versions. So
nice.
We've been needing
an app for a very long, very, very long time.
Well, you know, Mark, we've had some apps. There have been listeners who have made apps.
I thought there was just one.
No, actually, apparently there's more than one. Okay. There have been a couple of different apps. And the issue is when, you know, and I'm grateful for everybody who spent time making an LRN or Free Talk Live app in the past. But usually with volunteers, they kind of burn out.
You get what you pay for, right?
Yeah.
And we can't afford to pay for anything more than that.
How does it differ than like the TuneIn app? Or how is
it different?
Good question.
TuneIn would allow you to tune into thousands of streams from around the world. This only allows you to listen to LRN and Free Talk live streams. So it's an app specifically designed for LRN and Free Talk Live. There's links to the Facebook and the Twitter.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, there's going to be a link to the program guide in there. There were some other features I could have put in, but I decided not to. I wanted to just keep it simple.
So, like, if you're talking about an article, it might be linked in there.
Yeah, actually, the Free Talk Live feed, the Facebook feed is in there. So it's actually really easy to access
relevant.
That stuff.
Okay.
And so, you know, it's just a way for us to have an app. And that's kind of the thing these days, right? It's been a thing for a long time. It's just that getting an app will cost you probably at least $20,000, $50,000, $100,000, depending on, you know, the amount of features. You've been to the Peacekeeper If you've been to the Peacekeeper fundraiser, you know these things are a very expensive to program.
At pk.freetalklive.com, you'll get an idea of what they're trying to raise there.
So we avoided paying any of those costs because there'd be no way I would put that kind of money into an app. I don't expect this app to be a top 10 app or anything like that on the Google Play Store, but it's a nice thing to have if you can have it. And so basically what happened was the company that does the listen lines, if you've ever called the phone number that you can dial to listen to the show on your phone, some people do this, not a whole lot of them, but there's some people who do it. Yeah, it's interesting. The people who do it tend to do it a lot. Like, they listen frequently from their phone.
To me, I don't care about the sound quality of the of what I'm listening to, so the phone's
fine for me.
It's
definitely the poorest sound quality.
It is that, but it also is the best connection.
Yeah.
Right, because you don't have to have data.
I'd rather have low sound quality and less dropout, and you definitely get dropout with data.
Yeah, that's true. The phone line listen line does work as long as you've got a phone connection, so that's cool. And it's the same company that offers that. It's called a company called Audio Now. They actually approached me and they said, "Hey, we can give you an app for free." And I said, "Oh, really? Well, let me see what your apps look like." And they showed me some of the examples of, you know, here's what our app is, and it's basically kind of like the same format. So they basically have like a skeleton structure of an app that they can put different elements into. Mm-hmm. So it's not like they had to program this from scratch, but it still took a couple months for this thing to get tweaked and out the door. So this was a process, and I'm grateful that they spent the time on it. There's a small advertisement that is on the bottom of the screen during the app, but that's not very intrusive, and that's how they're monetizing this, right? So since we didn't pay for it, they sell a little bit of advertising just in, it's not a, you know, doesn't get in your way or anything like that. And so they collect whatever amount that they're selling that for.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. So I'm happy with it, and you can go get it. Go to either Android or apple.lrn.fm, or just go to the mobile site m.freetalklive.com. The links are right there at the top. And it's really important, if you download the app within the first 30 days, this is what the developer tells me, the first 30-day window is what they look at to see, oh, is this a popular app? Is this app worth, you know, featuring in the store's featured items? So I don't know if we're going to meet that criteria, but if you're going to download the app, doing it sooner rather than later would certainly be appreciated. And please rate the app 5 stars, hopefully, and also share the link on your social networking. And thank you in advance. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Texas secessionists are hitting the road, according to the Houston Chronicle and the Associated Press, to bring their message of a Lone Star Nation to more than 20 cities across the state. Today, the Texas Nationalist Movement is kicking off their Take Back Texas tour, with speaking dates booked at hotels and other venues throughout North, East, and Central Texas. The group says it aims to collect signatures to get Texas secession on the 2016 ballot. Now, that isn't actually possible, according to the story here. Only the legislature can get referendums on the ballot in Texas, but the separatists hope to court volunteers and supporters from across the state.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Sunday, the movement created a collection of Facebook events for each of their bookings. So far, the highest number of confirmed guests will turn up this evening in Tyler, Texas. That's 88 people, and on Wednesday in Fort Worth, 62. Now, of course, with Facebook events, they're really never accurate in my experience as far as how many people actually show up. You are usually above or below by some significant number, the number of people that will actually indicate they're going somewhere on one of these Facebook apps, but nonetheless, or the Facebook events. Nonetheless, I hope that they do see dozens of people turning out. They're going to be also going to several other cities at various different hotels. The Texas Nationalist Movement, or the TNM, could not be reached for comment on Monday. Secretary said all officials were out on the tour. In a statement on the group's website, President Daniel Miller said, quote, "This tour is our way of connecting with the thousands of Texans who have pledged their support to our cause and makes a statement about the direction of the Texas Nationalist Movement. The relentless march to identify, communicate with, and organize TNM supporters who are seeking to work for the independence of Texas is paramount at this point."
Now, I'm for there being sort of more nations as opposed to fewer. because I think that what we see is, you know, when you see this, you know, fractionalized national identity, is that people are getting better representation. If you're one person in 300 million, you're clearly not going to get the same representation as if you're one person in, say, if Wyoming seceded 600,000. That much is, you know, clear and obvious to me. There's nations like Iceland, for instance. I think they're, what are, you just looked it up, 30,000?
320,000.
320,000, I'm sorry. 320,000 people in Iceland. You know, you're going to get pretty good representation in Iceland, comparatively. But one of the things I wonder about is what is the value to Texas and to the people of Texas of not being in the United States?
Well, I don't live in Texas, so I guess I couldn't tell you that, but I can tell you from my perspective here in New Hampshire, the value is you're not in the United States. I mean, you don't have to pay taxes to the U.S. government to support war and to support imprisoning peaceful people for having a plant or for not paying taxes or whatever other
peaceful act. You think the people in Texas are concerned? I mean, they haven't legalized marijuana that I know of, so they're not concerned about the plant.
I saw a headline that the legislature did pass marijuana legalization.
I'd be willing to bet that the Texas legislature?
That's what I saw. I saw a headline. I didn't read the article.
Great. But at this point, still, Texas, pretty bad war on drug state.
It's pretty bad.
And also, I'd be willing to bet that Texas is in the top 10, the top quintile of states that provide people to the military. So I'm not thinking that they're a particularly anti-war state, generally. So, yeah, I mean, it would be great not to pay income taxes, but essentially everything the United States government does for Texas, they'll have to do on their own. Don't you think they'll raise an army relatively quickly?
I don't know, Mark, and I really don't care.
I mean, I know.
I support secession. I don't care if it's socialists or Texans or whoever it is that wants to secede. I say, do it. Get out there. Get out of there and create your own thing. I do have their website pulled up here, Mark, which is new to me, actually. I don't think I've ever been. I knew they had a secessionist movement, but maybe this is a new one or whatever. Well, I've never been here before.
I wonder if they're one of the states that pay a lot more money to the government than get to the government. Donor states, and if that's the case, I could see them.
There's a lot of reasons why people are upset with the federal government, Mark, and I'll go over their list of why Texas independence coming up in hour two.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
What's the matter, honey? Can't sleep?
Ugh, it's this heartburn. At night, it's the worst.
Heartburn? Again?
Yeah, I'm done with it. I'm going to kick acid with Rolaids.
Unlike Tums, new Rolaids Advanced goes to work instantly for combined powerful relief of your worst symptoms of heartburn, bloating, and gas.
Feeling better?
Much better.
That was fast.
Mm-hmm.
Kick acid and gas with new Rolaids Advanced.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.30 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,155 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $295. Antiwar.com reports remnants of the former Yemeni government loyal to Abd Rabu Mansour Hadi. The forces, allied with Saudi Arabia, yesterday launched a surprise attack on the international airport in the southern port city of Aden, seizing it and several nearby districts. The Shiite Houthis, who had been in control of the airport, insisted they withdrew from the city after cleansing it of Al-Qaeda forces. There has been fighting in the city for months throughout the Saudi-led war against the Houthis. The Hadi forces have made considerable gains against the Houthis in recent days after agreeing to a ceasefire which was supposed to begin Friday night and theoretically should still be in place. Throughout the ceasefire, the Saudis have continued to attack and the Hadi forces have taken advantage to seize territory. Hadi officials cheering the retaking of parts of Aden say they believe they'll have the whole city under their control in the coming days. Whether that will lead to new humanitarian aid shipments to the city or simply more Saudi military aid drops into the area remains to be seen. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. UPI reports cash-strapped Puerto Rico found little support among creditors for restructuring its $72 billion debt, some of which must be repaid in July. Representatives of the island Commonwealth met Monday in New York with over 300 representatives of investment firms, hedge funds, and insurance companies, but offered little information. It was the first meeting of government officials and creditors since Governor Alejandra Garcia Padilla acknowledged in June that Puerto Rico could not meet deadlines for debt payments on municipal bonds sold in the past decade. Melba Acosta of Puerto Rico's Government Development Bank told the creditors that they would have to accept adjusted terms of repayment, although she offered no details. Her comments followed recommendations 2 weeks ago by former International Monetary Fund officials who suggested bonds should be replaced with new bonds offering later maturities and reduced debt payments. She said, "I ask for your patience while we develop a credible plan." The Commonwealth has a history of balancing its budgets by borrowing, and its economy has declined since 2006. In the past 10 years, its population has declined by 7% as residents of the island sought employment opportunities in the continental United States. Among its debts are a $93.7 million payment due July 15th and another $140 million payment due on August 1st.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri on Tuesday put to death a man convicted of murdering a 19-year-old woman he encountered in a traffic accident in 2001 in the first execution in the United States since the Supreme Court upheld the use of lethal injection drugs. David Zink was pronounced dead at 7:41 p.m. Central Daylight Time after receiving a fatal dose of drugs in a state prison. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled on June 29th that a lethal injection drug used by Oklahoma, midazolam, did not violate the U.S. Constitution's ban on cruel and unusual punishment. The High Court did not directly address the constitutionality of the death penalty in the United States, but provoked a caustic debate among the justices. The Supreme Court on Tuesday denied several appeals from Zink's lawyers to halt the execution, including claims that Missouri officials would be violating federal laws by using pentobarbital obtained from a compounding pharmacy. Zink had been named the plaintiff in a lawsuit brought by a group of Missouri death row inmates who alleged the state's lethal injection protocol is unconstitutional and creates a substantial risk of severe pain. The allegations are part of a national debate about the use of compounding drugs in U.S. executions amid a shortage of traditionally used pharmaceuticals. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Coming up a little later, the 10 best careers for someone at your level of attractiveness.
Oh, but right now we have something truly incredible for you. Kenneth Quinn is a real-life psychic medium who claims that he can communicate with dead acquaintances. He's written a new book. It's called Small Talk from Beyond, Speaking with Distant Relatives and Friends of Friends Who Have Passed.
Hi, Kenneth.
Good to see you. Now, Kenneth, you've written that you're able to connect people with the spirits of their old college professors or roommates that they didn't really know that well. When did you realize that you had this gift?
Well, it was the day after my cousin's friend's wife's funeral. I was at home and I suddenly felt a presence in the room with me. And I heard a voice say, it's Vicky. Vicky Salchek, Dale's wife.
Wow.
We made a Tim's birthday thing a while back and we talked about how hard it is having a cat.
Fascinating.
This has been so amazing.
This has been fabulous. Thank you, Kenneth Quinn, for being our guest. Stay with us because coming up next, we're going to show you how to lose some of that excessive weight by constantly picking at your skin.
This is the Onion News Network.
Back now with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Tarrin.
And King Mark the First.
Yeah, we're going to continue with your phone calls and thoughts here. Also, Skype in, Skype username lrn.fm. We've got the Texas Nationalist Movement. I got their website pulled up because, Mark, you had asked, why do people in Texas, some people in Texas, want to leave the union? And so I've got their Q&A here from their website, which is thetnm.org. TNM as in Texas Nationalist Movement. TheTNM.org. We'll give you more from them here in just a moment. They're going on a speaking tour all around the state to spread the idea of secession. First, let's go to Brad calling on Skype. Brad, are you with us?
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Okay. You were just talking about your listen line. And last time I tried to call it, it says the number is no good anymore.
That's weird. There are a couple of different numbers. If you go to our listen page on the website at listen.freetalklive.com, you'll find two different numbers. And actually, the company that provides the main one is going to be changing that number soon. But it's my understanding that it was still operational. There have been every now and then there's been some downtime for those lines, and maybe you caught it at a bad time. Of course, if there is ever any kind of downtime, feel free to let me know, and I will investigate and try to get it remedied as quickly as possible. But we do have people listening to those lines on a monthly basis. I get statistics from them. So maybe you've got an old number that just hasn't been updated. I suspect that's probably what it is.
213.
Yeah, that's it. I'll have to check it here. I'll check it during the next break. But I checked the LRN one earlier today, I think, and it was working. So I don't know what to tell you.
I'll try again.
Was there anything else you wanted to actually talk about on the radio?
No. That's it.
Okay. Well, thanks for the call. I appreciate it. Generally, you want to keep away from tech support calls. I mean, on Free Talk Live, it's just, you know, not particularly valuable to the listening audience because most people aren't listening via the listen line. It is one of those services that we provide for folks just, you know, to give you another option to get the show. Anyway, you can also find those listen line numbers or one of the listen line numbers on the mobile site at m.freetalklive.com. And this new app, by the way, the Free Talk Live /LRN app actually has a phone line listening option in it. So when you're in the app, if you want to use the app to make the phone call, it's got the number programmed right in there. Very cool. And if you want to grab the app, you can go to android.lrn.fm or apple.lrn.fm, and it'll take you to the appropriate store pages to download. Of course, it's free. So Ian, Tarrin, and Mark in the studio, Texas Independence, Secession, they're going around on a speaking tour. And let's see here. Let me continue with the Houston Chronicle, and then we'll get to their website as to why Texas Independence. What are their reasons for wanting to leave the union? Back to the Houston Chronicle and the AP. Since the re-election of Barack Obama in 2012, the movement has repeatedly vowed to get secession on a statewide November ballot. But according to Mark Jones, the chair of the Political Science Department at Rice University, they can't do it with a petition. So unlike some states where you can just get hundreds of thousands of petition signatures and get something on the ballot, can't do it that way in Texas. He says gathering signatures could be a good public relations tool, but from a constitutional legal perspective, it's irrelevant in Texas. There's no way for individual citizens to place any item on the statewide ballot. Only the state legislature can do that, and there are steps to take before a statewide vote on leaving the union. A legislator would have to introduce a resolution to convene a constitutional convention at which to discuss secession, and the state house and senate would have to approve the resolution with a two-thirds majority, which is not likely. But since the legislature won't meet again until January of 2017, Texas governor, they don't meet every year in Texas?
Some legislatures meet every other year.
Interesting. Texas Governor Greg Abbott would have to call a special session to discuss secession, which is virtually unthinkable, said Jones, the political science chair.
They're planning ahead for it. I don't see that as a particular problem.
What they're saying here is that the Texas nationalist movement wants to get the issue on the ballot in 2016.
Yeah.
Houston Chronicle is pointing out, or the AP is pointing out,
that ain't gonna happen.
It's not possible unless there's a special session that's called. And what are the odds of that happening?
Slim.
Slim to none. So furthermore, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled in 1869 that the states have no right to secede.
This is ridiculous. I mean, this is absolute. It's a suicide pact. The Constitution has become a suicide pact. There is no other agreement that into which I understand that you can enter that you cannot get out. But states who aren't even anything but collections of humans. So humans can enter in. This is the only agreement where you may not leave. I mean, the Supreme Court sounds like King George, from which the United States seceded in the first place. I'll tell you what. They can secede. They can shoot all of you and leave. That's what they did the first time.
Mm-hmm. Since the legislature, the federal government, he says, would certainly view any attempt at secession as something unconstitutional and would move to block it, said Jones. However, that hasn't stopped Texans from mulling the notion. Even then, Governor Rick Perry suggested Texas would leave the union while addressing a 2009 Tea Party rally in Austin. In January of 2013, shortly after the beginning of Obama's second term, more than 100,000 people, remember this, signed a petition.
That's what I was going to refer to, yes.
Asking for the president to kindly excuse Texas from the Union of States. In September of 2014, Reuters polled about 9,000 Americans on secession and surprisingly found about a quarter of them would support their state seceding. The Southwest supported the highest approval rating for secession at 34%. When KSAT TV in San Antonio reported on the TNM's push in 2013, they conducted a viewer poll asking if Texans should have the right to secede. Of about 600 respondents, 75% answered yes. TNM made headlines when Politico reported one of its members had been consorting with Russian officials at a St. Petersburg conference, calling himself the foreign minister of Texas.
That's funny.
A rebel government in Ukraine also told international media they were friends with the Texas secessionists and even invited the Lone Star representatives to a summit of unrecognized states. Should invite Liberland to that one. That summit, by the way, has been indefinitely postponed due to war, according to a spokesman for the Ukrainian rebels. So that's the latest from Texas, where the speaking tour is kicking off tonight, I think it was. Is that tonight? It was actually tonight.
Do they have a secessionist national convention? Have you guys ever heard of anything like that where all the different state parties get together and BS?
I think they did that.
10th Amendment Center, but better.
I think they did that in Vermont one year, but I could be wrong about that.
I just had no clue if there's actually any organization or not.
There are, I think it's a loosely affiliated bunch of groups. I don't think there's anything.
Oh, yeah, I imagine. Yeah.
I would assume so. Just curious if there was a convention.
So, get the secessionists together. What a funny thing.
You got the Vermont secessionists, New Hampshire secessionists. You've got Texas. There's people that just want the South to secede. There's
Georgia, when I was there, there was one time where the state Senate was so mad, it was over 50%. I think it was 52% threatened to secede. I think it was over Obamacare.
What was it, a resolution? I mean, how did they get
the numbers?
Yeah,
it was like a resolution. It wasn't anything with teeth, but it was something they put up. I have an old report about it on my page somewhere, an LCL report, but it was a few years back.
It's Lowland Country Report.
Low Country Liberty Report. Just look for Tarrin Lupo on YouTube. You'll find it. And then type in the word 52% secession. You'll see the story.
There's, Hawaiian secession movement. There's the Alaskan secession movement as well. The state of Jefferson is another one. Free State of Jones, maybe. I don't know if they're still around, but there's been a number of them.
Alaska. There's quite a few, yeah.
Yeah. So those are the ones off the top of my head.
Now, Jefferson is simply a secessionist movement from a state. So the idea is that Northern California and Southern Oregon would get together and create a new state. There's also
North Colorado.
North Colorado was another one. So those are different but similar. And there's people, you know, seceding micronations all the time. Some put more effort into it than others do. You know, I mean,
didn't you secede Edgewood Farms?
I have you know, talked about doing it. You know, now and back and forth and up.
You're
and
calling
down.
Yourself the king. I mean, they pretty much.
Oh no, I'm intergalactic king of everything. It doesn't really have anything to do with my particular property. I'm just king of everything. But. You know, I mean, there's people that do that. Like, for instance, when somebody calls themselves Tire Kingdom, there used to be Tire Kingdom in Bradenton and Sarasota, the Suncoast area. What are they doing? You know, I mean, aren't they to some extent seceding also?
So we don't owe taxes anymore. We are the Tire Kingdom.
Yeah, yes. What happens to Burger King?
Right.
All right. More on the way here in moments. Why Texas independence? We got the Q&A here from their website. What are their reasons for this? 855-450-FREE, and what are your reasons for supporting secession?
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business? CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners. So you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you, of course, can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can also go and get some Bitcoin right now at expresscoin.com. You can do it with money order or check. And if you want to get Litecoin or Dogecoin, they've got those too. It's your best choice for getting cryptocurrencies. ExpressCoin.com. They are a licensed money services business. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you at ExpressCoin.com. You can do it from your smartphone with their app, which is also available at ExpressCoin.com, or just use the website. Coupon code FTL will save you on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency. You'll pay zero to transfer your cash into Bitcoin with code FTL on up to $40. Beyond $40, it's a mere 3% transfer fee, which is a great deal. Go to expresscoin.com and use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, at expresscoin.com. I use them to get my cryptocurrency. They're excellent at it. So our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. And by the way, I don't think they really advertise this too much, but they'll do the reverse too. So if you are looking to cash out your Bitcoin into U.S. dollars, or I presume they can do Canadian reverse as well. You can do that with ExpressCoin, so that's also a cool service.
Yeah.
Yep, I've done that too. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. To the Texas Nationalist Movement, why Texas independence? Because, Mark, you had asked this of the universe a moment ago. Why are they doing this? What is their motivation for it? It's not necessarily that they're anti-war, is it? It's Texas, right? Here are some of the reasons listed on their website, which is thetnm.org. The reasons for Texas independence are clear and simple. The people of Texas believe that Texans are best governed by Texans.
I believe the people of Texas do believe that, yes.
We are no longer willing to be subjected to policies that we don't want by people that we don't elect. If you'd like a breakdown of some of the highlights of why Texans want independence, read below. Texas gets a government that begins and ends in Texas. No matter what our priorities, challenges, dreams, or decisions are here in Texas, while we are part of the Union, everything is ultimately dictated from or allowed by the bureaucrats in D.C. Independence means that Texans, and Texans alone, decide our fate. Texans are tired, this is in italics and bold, of being governed by bureaucrats we didn't elect, pushing policies that we don't want.
Well, I don't imagine Texans would be tired of that at all. I mean, you know, for instance, with the American Revolution, they didn't get rid of the government. They just got rid of the current government.
Well, sure. They're suggesting, though, that if they had the Texas national government, that at least then their government would be their own people. And that doesn't mean that there wouldn't be policies that they would disagree with. But at least then people outside of their borders wouldn't have an influence on those things.
That much is true.
Independence, they say, is what the people of Texas want. Contrary to the marginalizing of the issue by our opposition, the people of Texas have consistently and in increasing numbers expressed their support for the full independence of Texas. A 2009 research poll showed that 50% of Republicans, 40% of independents, and 15% of Democrats believe that Texas should stand as an independent nation.
You know, it was funny during this whole, the last year's kerfuffle about secession and stuff, it was the Democrats making fun of southern states. I don't know if Texas is a donor state or a state that gets more more at back than it spends, but they were saying, like, yeah, isn't it funny that the states that get the most from the federal government want to get rid of it the most? Well, yeah, I suppose it's funny, but why wouldn't you want to let them? I mean, really, why do you want to hold together this? Democrats, please explain to me, why do you want to hold together a government of people that don't want to be here?
Well, it depends on who you ask. I mean, there was an article written by a lefty who was in total support of states like Texas leaving.
Sure. You just read the statistic, Ian. Yes, 15% of Democrats said that they would be supported if Texas
leaving. Well, I bet you those numbers would be different if that poll was taken in the year 2002. You know what I mean?
Whereas
Republicans would probably be happier to be in the union at that time.
Are 85% of Democrats stupid enough to believe that there won't be a Republican president in the relatively near future? Is that what you're saying?
I'm not saying anything about
that. I am. Go ahead. I think you're absolutely right.
I'd
say that's true for Republicans, too.
I think a lot of people will say secession's a good idea when they're polled. But then when they get asked, well, what happens to my Social Security? Yeah. What happens to my... Oh, you mean I don't get to get this government money? Well, no, I don't want to do that.
That's exactly...
You know, that's what's going to happen.
That's exactly it. And one of the reasons I think that secession for states is really... It's over with this conversation. Nullification, that's fine. States telling the government, take a long walk off a short pier on this issue or that issue. You know, real ID or...
Yeah.
You know, spying on our citizens or whatever. Even income tax. You could conceivably, a state could say, the citizens of our state don't even need to pay income tax any longer. But when it comes to something like, Social Security, these people who paid in for years and years and years, they want their money back out.
Yeah, I'm not sure how to handle all the Medicare people and all that. But what I will say is... I think it's important to bring this up and talk about it because they need to be ready. When the dollar collapses one way or the other, this is happening.
Yeah, it's not over.
I mean, it's not like, but I think it's nice to get people ready.
It's not over, Mark. To say that this is over, I'm sorry. No, just because the Civil War settled this question doesn't mean it's over. There are people who are interested in this now, and they're interested in it for a good reason, and talking about secession brings us closer to making it happen. I realize that it's politically infeasible, it seems impossible, but I think it is possible if you get enough people to believe
it's
going to
happen. The fact is the United States federal government is spending itself into insolvency, so I agree with you that people need to be ready for it, but I don't think once people say, oh my God, you're right, there won't be any Medicare. Remember, the voting populace tends to be an older populace. And what happened to my Social Security? I paid into this stuff for years. Texas can't match the federal funds. They didn't get those funds.
Let's go to Stephen. He's actually in Texas, in Waco. Stephen, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, welcome.
It's the first time ever calling into a radio station.
Thanks.
Enjoy the show. I listen to you all streaming. You used to be live on the radio station here, but I guess they dropped you all.
Yeah, they kind of went a different direction on their weekends. But go ahead.
I was calling in about the secessionist movements. First of all, let me say that I am totally in support of a state's right to secede or part of a state's right to secede. I don't really see anything that holds them back. And if they want to be their own country or their own state, I really don't see a problem with that. Now, that being said, it worries me a little bit if Texas were to secede. Because we have some really backwards thinking here, and as much as I loathe the federal government, they've actually done some things that have made Texas a better place. And for example, I believe in 2003, we had a sodomy law struck down where a man in Houston brought charges against Texas for a lawsuit because the police raided his apartment by accident and caught him and his lover in the act of sex.
Oh, my. And they actually arrested him for it.
Yes, they arrested both of them.
Wow.
Charged both of them with sodomy, which was illegal. And they went to the Supreme Court, won, and that overturned the sodomy law. And
if you want to hang on, Stephen, we can bring it back here. But I got to say that even if you can point out a couple of things that the federal government has done,
you'll never convince Ian.
It's not worth.
You'll never convince.
It's not worth all the terrible things that the federal government has done. It's
you
not,
can't talk
I'll
to
trade
an ideal.
I'll trade it any day.
It's a high price.
More coming up.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget, freeross.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
An alarming UN report on magical realism released this week warns of increased incidences of women's tears flooding the entire world. A UN committee linked the catastrophic phenomena to matronly widows, commonly named Tita and Esmeralda, who wept for up to 90 days on end about their estranged lovers.
Just consider how detrimental it is to a nation's workforces to have thousands of its plantation overseers simply disappear one night into the midsummer fog, only to return decades later without having aged a single day. Put simply, if such phenomena are not immediately halted, the effects on the international community will be catastrophic.
The nation's limo drivers spent a magical prom night playing scratch-off tickets in the parking lot this week. According to sources, chauffeurs nationwide began their enchanting evening by cramming swank magazines into their glove compartments before dropping off their students at a school gym, working through a stunning assortment of lotto cards, and dining upon a wide range of microwave-heated taquitos from a nearby 7-Eleven.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Secession is once again on the table. Mark says it's not possible. Which, of course, you know, I hope that you're wrong about that, Mark. We're going to continue. We'll take your calls.
Fantasy.
855-450-FREE. You got to dream big if you want to have a chance at making something like that happen. And well, secession is definitely a big dream. A lot of people share that dream. And the more people that can see that vision, the more people that can understand it, the better we're all.
Definitely coming. And I think that the younger population is getting much more aware. And I understand that the young population never votes.
It's
I get
true.
That, unfortunately, but I really think, like I said, just Medicare alone is predicted to just be more than the federal budget. Just alone, Medicare, not the war effort, just taking care of sick people and mainly brain patients, Alzheimer's and long-term care patients. I was mentioning the other show that they're going to exceed the whole national budget. When that starts happening, I don't understand how they're going to keep the House of Cards together.
It can't.
And the young people. The younger people are, as Ernest Hancock says, they're kind of just waiting around for the older people to go. So, you know, all these benefits go with them.
Well,
and
I'd say that
I hate to say it like
if
that.
If I was conspiracy minded, I'd say death panels. I mean, you know, people were already talking about, and you know, as far as the federal government goes, the concern that you know, that the whole reason for Obamacare was these death panels. So,
well, I think what'll happen is, you know, when the dollar collapses or they can't afford this stuff, you'll see a cheaper black market open up and solve a lot of problems. When
like black market and Alzheimer care.
Well, yeah, why not? Because you could just have people who are not, how much of this goes on in the country now where someone's just paying someone under the table to watch grandma
for
a little while
happening.
And they're not real employees. They're not paying, you know, benefits. They're not paying anything like that. And that happens all the time. So I could imagine there's some under the table service that would handle that for you.
We got
you.
Steven. He's back with us in Waco. Was going over Texas secession from his perspective. You were talking about the federal government and some of the reasons why, or some of the good things that, in your opinion, they've done to make Texas a better place. Do we have Steven? Steven in Waco? Steven,
can you hear me?
Yeah, we got you now. Go ahead.
Yes. I don't know that it necessarily outweighs all the bad things.
No way in hell it outweighs the bad things.
You can't say anything good about the federal government to Ian.
Think about all the people that the federal government has been responsible for murdering and putting in prison over all of the years. I mean, I'm sorry about the guys that were in the middle of a sex act with one another where the Texas government goons broke in and actually arrested them, and that case got overturning the Texas sodomy law. So I'm sorry about that, but I'd rather have it where we had 50 different state governments and no federal government, and then you know there would still be states in there where there's no sodomy laws, right? So like the people who want freedom to do sodomy could go to those states, and then we'd have, you know, more specified setups of law in different states, and people could pick the best fit for them, and that's better, right?
Hold on, Ian. We're talking about Texas secession here, not 49.
One
50
goes,
states.
And a bunch of others are going to go. If Texas goes,
I
if Vermont goes.
Understand. I completely understand, and there's no doubt that I definitely sympathize with you. I totally agree with the 50 laboratories of democracy, republicanism, whatever you want to call it. I just think people should be more aware of what they're going to be getting into if they decide to secede. And I'm glad that y'all brought up the point of low voter turnout earlier, because here in Texas, I mean, for example, 76% of Texans support changing marijuana laws, yet less than probably a quarter of our politicians support it.
Oh, yeah.
So our politicians are not representative of us. And that tells
of course
me
not.
That people aren't getting out and getting involved in voting. And
it wouldn't matter. It really wouldn't matter. I mean, we've seen it where people have gotten involved and the politicians still don't care. I mean, they just kind of do whatever it is they want to do.
Do you remember when they tried to push Obamacare and people were calling in like 100-1 telling their politicians not to do it, and they did it anyway?
And don't forget the bailout too. Remember when they
the
banker bailout?
Yeah, we've seen it in action just last year, you know, and a year before. It doesn't really matter. They don't listen. I mean, the idea that you represent, it's kind of a joke.
Steven, anything else you want to share tonight?
Well, I just had one more question for y'all. It didn't pertain to secession though.
All right.
New Hampshire is. It's called the Live Free or Die State, correct?
It is. Just
okay.
A slogan.
So, yeah, just a slogan. So I'm wondering, I'm a reporter for Cannabis News here in Texas. So
cool.
I was wondering, of all the places, why is there no marijuana legalization in New Hampshire?
It's an excellent question. So here's my best answer as somebody who has been observing the efforts to legalize or decriminalize or remove prohibition of marijuana in New Hampshire over the last decade that I've been here. Or thereabouts. And I think there are a couple different reasons, because New Hampshire is actually behind the ball on this issue compared to all of the surrounding New England states. Every other New England state has had some form of decriminalization. In fact, Maine has had it since back in the 1970s. And New Hampshire is behind the ball. It's definitely the worst of all the states. And that's even though we have, you know, hundreds of liberty activists, over 1,000 people, 1,500 people who moved here as part of the Free State Project. Now, of course, not all of those 1,500 are active on the cannabis issue, so there's that. So we need more people moving here. But why hasn't it happened thus far? New Hampshire has a government that is fairly, I don't know, ornery, if you want to use that word. It's stubborn. It's not likely to to grow in size, but it's also not very easy to shrink it down from where it is. So it's already a very, very small government compared to other states, and that's a good thing. But the areas that the government has clawed its way into, like this insane war on drugs and the war on cannabis, it's going to be more difficult to remove its claws or the tentacles of the Leviathan from around that particular issue. That said, we've seen amazing success over the last few years where now in New Hampshire, both the state House and the state Senate have voted for decriminalization.
And the state House was total decriminalization, right?
The state House voted for legalization. If I'm recalling correctly, and the state Senate, I don't think, went that far.
There is a difference.
Oh, yes.
There is a big difference. But what we had, basically what we had happen here was the Senate was going to vote for legalization, or excuse me, the Senate was going to vote for decrim this year, but there was a last minute situation that ended up not working out because of the governor essentially promising she was going to veto it. So we're basically right on the cusp of it. I mean, we've had, you were talking about the difference in the people of Texas and what the representatives are doing. You said 70-something percent of people in Texas support legalization, but only a fraction of people in the state representatives were voting for it. Here, we had more than 80% of the state House vote for marijuana decriminalization this year. So that should give you an indication of where things are going here. To me, it's just a matter of time in New Hampshire. It's sad that we're not leading the way on this particular issue, but it could be that when the tide turns, that New Hampshire could lead the way. Like, it may be that even though New Hampshire is really slow, maybe we'll see New Hampshire legalize or end prohibition sooner than we'll see the surrounding states. Maybe it'll jump to that quicker than the other ones got to it. I don't know. We'll see.
It's pretty much all being blocked by the governor, right? It's basically one lady that's stopping all this.
One lady that's tied to the police unions, yes.
And yeah. I mean, over and over, it is.
Yeah, she will veto it.
No. He asks, is there a veto-proof majority?
Not yet.
There is definitely one in the state representatives that's overwhelming. I mean, 80% voted for decrim this year. The state Senate, I don't think we have a veto-proof majority there yet. But again, we're still
it's close. You
know, we're just getting the ball started here, and we've had amazing levels of difference. So I'll give you another example. I've been to a lot of these hearings where they've had the cannabis decrim, cannabis legalization, and I've seen the way the state reps who are on the panels that are hearing these issues treat this issue. Back in the beginning days when I was going, you know, in the late part of the last decade, they were much more dismissive towards this issue, laughing about it, just, you know, like this was a big joke.
Yucking it up. They totally were.
Yeah. And now many of them have changed their minds, you know, because here in New Hampshire, you can actually talk to these people. You can actually stop them in the hallway and they'll have a conversation with you. You can call them at their home. And they'll pick up the phone and talk to you in a lot of cases.
There's 400 of them. They get paid $100 a year. They don't have an office. They've got a little cubby hole.
They're not professional politicians.
There's not even a lock on their mailbox. You know.
Go ahead, Stephen. Go ahead.
You know, up until the last legislative session in 2013, they laughed at us. They didn't care. They openly dismissed it. This year, we took 400 people to the state capitol, and they changed their tune. We actually got some bills out of committee.
It's a step in the right direction. Stephen, thanks for the call tonight. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are FortressSurvivalLLC.com.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio, now at your fingertips.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've also got Skype. Skype usernames, lrn.fm. Secession is once again on the table here with the Texas Nationalist Movement, the TNM.org. They are going on a speaking tour at different hotels around the state. They, you know, they're booking a room. They're putting the word out that, hey, want to learn about secession? Come on out. We'll talk about it. And I think that's an important thing to do. I think this is a smart move. And I would like to see the Foundation for New Hampshire Independence emulate this, because this makes sense. And I don't imagine it's too expensive to book a hotel room for an hour or two. You know, if it's in a weekday evening or
like
something like that,
conference room or something.
Yeah, like a conference room. I mean, I've booked hotel rooms. I put together Keenevention, which is happening October 30th through November 1st this year here in Keene. It's a convention where it's very intimate, where people come to a big hotel room and they meet, and there's speechifying that goes on. In fact, Tarrin, you're going to be heading up one of the panels this year.
I am. I'm excited. I have some speakers all lined up.
Oh, really? Yeah. You've gotten on that, then. I appreciate that, because we just talked about it this week. I invited Tarrin, since he is a newbie to New Hampshire. You're certainly not new to New Hampshire. You've been here visiting for years, but you just made the move officially as part of the Free State Project this year, which makes you a new mover. And we're bringing back the New Movers panel at this year's Keenevention. It happened the first year. It didn't happen the second year. So, wait, no. maybe it didn't happen the first year and it happened the second year. Anyway, we're bringing back the new movers panel because it's fun. We're going to have an old school movers panel, like so people who've been here for a long time. And actually Dennis Goddard has stepped up to take that one on. So
right,
I think that's going to be fun. Yeah,
he's always controversial.
He's come back into the activism world, and I thought this would be a cool way to get Dennis out there again. And he's somebody who's been here for a long time, and so he knows a lot of people who've been here for a while. So we'll have the newbie panel, we'll have the old school panel, and each panel will kind of talk about their perspective on what it's like to be here in New Hampshire. And of course, there's going to be people visiting Keene Venture from around the country who, you know, want to see what it's like to live here and get your experience. So thank you, Tarrin, in advance.
Yeah, I'm excited.
For heading
I've always wanted
up.
To come.
Keenvention.info, that's how you can join us. It's $60 that gets you in for the whole weekend, and pretty much that money's going to pay for the hotel room, right? Because I was talking about renting hotel rooms.
Yeah, that is so dirt cheap for a conference.
It's a really good price.
Really dirt cheap.
Plus, you also get into the Hallow Keen costume dance party for the same ticket price.
That's right, so which that's is included. The whole reason most of us are going.
It's a lot of fun. We did it for the first time last year, and it's going to be even better this year. We got a better venue that's going to let us go later. The Hallow Keen party had to end at midnight this last year. This year, Halloween actually happens to fall on Halloween night, and in addition, that we'll be able to go later to like 1:30, so we will go past the witching hour on Halloween this year. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Go to keenvention.info. You can get your tickets for either credit card through Eventbrite, or you can do Bitcoin. So it's up to you. keenvention.info. Let's go to Jeffrey in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Jeffrey.
Oh, hello. I just wanted to say you guys are doing great work.
Thanks, Jeffrey. Go ahead.
I love the show. I just want to make a quick point, and then I wanted to hear your thoughts on it. Last year Great Britain had a referendum for Scotland to secede. This is about the secession issue.
Right.
We've been talking about. The fact that, you know, and I'm not trying to pick on the British, but you look at, like, Great Britain, and they're not a very libertarian-friendly country. They have socialized medicine. You've got to jump through hoops and hurdles to get a gun or even get a license for them to even think you get a license. And here they go, like last year, and they get they had a referendum where Scotland could secede from Great Britain. And I kind of find that ridiculous that you look back here in the United States and you look at like Texas and they don't have the right to succeed legally according to the system.
Secede. According to Texas's problem is that there's no way for essentially somebody to put something on the ballot. There's no way to do that here in New Hampshire, and many states don't let you have a sort of a referendum or a I can't remember what the other terminology for it is, but when you have people vote on an issue specifically, they many states just don't have that. Many of the Western states do. Florida kind of does because you can vote on an amendment to the Constitution, but it's not actually a referendum for an issue.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, that's it. Basically, the problem isn't with the U.S. Constitution in this circumstance. It is a problem with the Texas Constitution. Now, I should say that that the Constitution of the United States should have an exit clause. Any contract should have an exit clause. And then what should that exit clause look like? So that should be offered in every state. And I'm not sure what it should look like. Should it be that 50% of the people vote on something? Should it be 60 or 66 or 75% of people in a given geographic area want to secede from the government? I don't imagine you get any kind of numbers like that, especially when we're talking about Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security handed out by the federal government. But there should be an exit clause.
Yeah, I totally agree. I find that just very weird that you look at like what happened in Great or what could have happened. And yeah, there is probably, depending on who you ask over in Britain, the fact that, there was a lot of backdoor deals to keep Scotland part of Britain. I just kind of find it just very odd that, a country that tends to have a slightly bigger government than the United States. And once again, I'm not picking on people from Britain. But I just find that very just mind blowing that could have happened.
It was close.
Year.
It was darn close.
Right, yes.
And I actually saw a headline recently that says that secession has been getting more popular in Scotland since the vote. So now if it were put on the ballot again, some people are saying it might actually pass. And so the question is how long before it's put on for a second time, because they got it on once. Why can't they get it on a second time? Just keep putting it on. Just keep putting the question on, keep persuading people, and try again. Thank you, Jeffrey, for your call tonight. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yep, you're welcome. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. We've got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. We're rolling down the list here of the Texas National Movement. Excuse me, Texas Nationalist Movement, TNM, as to why they say Texans want independence from the United States. Number three on their list, Texas gets a government that we choose. They say Texans have lost their voice inside their own government. Every campaign cycle, Texas candidates are recipients of massive amounts of cash from outside of Texas. The interests of those outside of Texas have stifled the voice of actual Texas voters. This has led to massive voter apathy, as many have given up on the process. Independence means the door shuts on the interests from the outside of Texas and a return of power back into the hands of Texans. Now, I mean, it's certainly true that international companies will still be interested in influencing Texas politics, even if Texas secedes. This isn't one of the most persuasive reasons that I've seen for secession, but I guess, I don't really see how seceding is going to stop outside influence. It'll certainly stop the influence of people from California sending their representatives, or people from, Washington State or Montana or wherever, sending reps to D.C. to make policies that affect Texas. It will certainly stop that. But, like, if big money oil companies want to come in there, they're still going to do that, right?
Yeah, there's going to be, people are going to be swayed by moneyed interests in the same way that people are going to be swayed by the moneyed interests of the United States government. It's the reason I say that secession's not going anywhere, because they're worried about their Social Security checks. They're worried about their Medicare. I mean, the people that are getting...
How can you say it's not
going
anywhere?
Listen to me just a second. This is really important. Medicare is currently, the people who are getting Medicare have paid in about 25 to 30 cents on the dollar for what they're getting in medical care. Now, those numbers aren't really going to straighten out as medical care gets more and more expensive as time goes by. So you're essentially talking about welfare programs. People love free crap. I mean, look at Bernie Sanders right now. Basically, he's done everything.
Jesse Ventura's backing him. I saw that today.
Wonderful. He's done everything but promise everybody pony.
Like, it just goes to show Jesse Ventura is not a libertarian.
No. I just actually put a Facebook meme out, and I'm running for president on the sole platform is I'm going to give away more free crap than Bernie Sanders. Come on, America. Okay. More free crap than Bernie Sanders.
Can you beat Vermin Supreme? I mean, he's talking about free ponies.
Yeah. Everything Bernie Sanders says, doubled. That's what I'm running on. Twice all the free stuff Bernie Sanders is giving away. Because this is what people need to understand. There's no such thing as a free lunch. There is no free lunch. There's no free college. There's no free medical. There's no free education. There's no free anything. Nothing's free. You got to work to improve things. That's it. That's our lot in life. Sorry about it.
You mean it doesn't count as work to go and punch a Chad?
No, it doesn't. No. It does. In the United States, it does. And this is why it's going to collapse. Texas isn't going to secede because there's too many people there that want free money. The United States is going to collapse because too many people.
Negativity.
Look, I'm looking, talking about realism.
Yeah, but look, I mean,
you don't have a rebuttal. That's why you don't appreciate it.
I've got a rebuttal. The rebuttal is that you've already got like a quarter of Americans who are willing to see secession happen. That's a good starting point.
I'm willing to see it happen too. But wait until those people find out there'll be no government check.
855.
That's going to happen anyway.
That's true as well. But whether they see that coming is another question.
That's not secession. That's governmental collapse.
855, 450-FREE. More coming up. Hour 3 is on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
Hey guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
Improve the look of your home for less with hardwood floors from Lumber Liquidators. Choose from over 400 styles of hardwood, bamboo, woodlook tile, and more, all for a lot less than other stores. This week, get gorgeous Amber City Strand bamboo for just $1.99 and more hardwood floors from 99 cents. Special coupon savings on all Bellawood pre-finished hardwood with best-in-class scratch resistance. North American and European laminate from 49 cents and more.
And 18-month special financing.
For the floor you want at the price you deserve, visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.30 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,155 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $295. Antiwar.com reports remnants of the former Yemeni government loyal to Abd Rabu Mansour Hadi. The forces, allied with Saudi Arabia, yesterday launched a surprise attack on the international airport in the southern port city of Aden, seizing it and several nearby districts. The Shiite Houthis, who had been in control of the airport, insisted they withdrew from the city after cleansing it of Al-Qaeda forces. There has been fighting in the city for months throughout the Saudi-led war against the Houthis. The Hadi forces have made considerable gains against the Houthis in recent days after agreeing to a ceasefire which was supposed to begin Friday night and theoretically should still be in place. Throughout the ceasefire, the Saudis have continued to attack and the Hadi forces have taken advantage to seize territory. Hadi officials cheering the retaking of parts of Aden say they believe they'll have the whole city under their control in the coming days. Whether that will lead to new humanitarian aid shipments to the city or simply more Saudi military aid drops into the area remains to be seen.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com.
UPI reports cash-strapped Puerto Rico found little support among creditors for restructuring its $72 billion debt, some of which must be repaid in July. Representatives of the island Commonwealth met Monday in New York with over 300 representatives of investment firms, hedge funds, and insurance companies, but offered little information. It was the first meeting of government officials and creditors since Governor Alejandra Garcia Padilla acknowledged in June that Puerto Rico could not meet deadlines for debt payments on municipal bonds sold in the past decade. Melba Acosta of Puerto Rico's Government Development Bank told the creditors that they would have to accept adjusted terms of repayment, although she offered no details. Her comments followed recommendations 2 weeks ago by former International Monetary Fund officials who suggested bonds should be replaced with new bonds offering later maturities and reduced debt payments. She said, "I ask for your patience while we develop a credible plan." The Commonwealth has a history of balancing its budgets by borrowing, and its economy has declined since 2006. In the past 10 years, its population has declined by 7% as residents of the island sought employment opportunities in the continental United States. Among its debts are a $93.7 million payment due July 15th and another $140 million payment due on August 1st.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri on Tuesday put to death a man convicted of murdering a 19-year-old woman he encountered in a traffic accident in 2001 in the first execution in the United States since the Supreme Court upheld the use of lethal injection drugs. David Zink was pronounced dead at 7:41 p.m. Central Daylight Time after receiving a fatal dose of drugs in a state prison. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled on June 29th that a lethal injection drug used by Oklahoma, midazolam, did not violate the U.S. Constitution's ban on cruel and unusual punishment. The High Court did not directly address the constitutionality of the death penalty in the United States, but provoked a caustic debate among the justices. The Supreme Court on Tuesday denied several appeals from Zink's lawyers to halt the execution, including claims that Missouri officials would be violating federal laws by using pentobarbital obtained from a compounding pharmacy. Zink had been named the plaintiff in a lawsuit brought by a group of Missouri death row inmates who alleged the state's lethal injection protocol is unconstitutional and creates a substantial risk of severe pain. The allegations are part of a national debate about the use of compounding drugs in U.S. executions amid a shortage of traditionally used pharmaceuticals. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Right now, it's looking like tonight's record $500 million Powerball drawing could be canceled, as embarrassed lottery officials have admitted they lost the balls. Douglas Braunstein, deputy director of the Multi-State Lottery Association, addressed the press moments ago. We have a quote. We know how important the balls are to a successful drawing. I saw them the other day, and I'm sure they'll turn up somewhere. Braunstein says it's usually marketing director Ben Callahan's job to keep an eye on the balls, but when reached for comment, Callahan said he just sits next to the balls. It's not his job to know where they are every second of every day. According to Braunstein, it's crucial they find the balls before tonight's drawing. Quote, we'd love to use different balls, but these ones have the numbers on them. Braunstein added that once they figure out where the balls are, they promise to keep them in some sort of case instead of just lying around the office. When we return, we'll meet some of the undeterred Powerball superfans who are camping out before the big drawing dressed as their favorite numbers.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You may dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Tarrin P. Lupo.
And King Mark the First.
We've been talking about secession. Still to come here tonight, there's a bizarre story from Portland that Tarrin and I have involving rubber sex objects being thrown over the power lines. And we'll tell you more about that here in a little bit. But the news is that the Texas Nationalist Movement has kicked off a speaking tour. They're going to be in 20 different cities around Texas, various different parts of Texas, be speaking in hotel rooms and to hopefully crowds of hopefully hundreds, maybe dozens at the very least, about the idea of secession. It's an idea that's time has come again, and it's time to do it peacefully and successfully. I think it can be done. Mark, you're saying it can't. Tarrin, you're kind of where
I'm
are
mixed.
You at?
I think it can happen if the dollar really starts getting weak enough that people can't get their Medicare money or they're starting to have problems. Then all
that's
of a sudden they're going to be on board.
Yeah, I think that's definitely true. I mean, if the federal government starts to fail at sending out its checks.
Yeah, because it won't happen overnight. They'll kind of delay checks. They'll pull magic tricks. Everything's okay. We'll figure it out. We'll fund it. And it won't be like all of a sudden they don't get checks. It'll slowly get bad and then crash.
So we've been going through the list of reasons because, Mark, you'd asked the question, why? Why do people in Texas want independence? Specifically, why does the Texas Nationalist Movement want it? And it just happens to be a page on their website with those answers. So just to briefly recap, we've been through three of them so far. Texas gets a government that begins and ends in Texas. Independence is what the people of Texas want, and Texas gets a government that we choose. Moving on to number four, an end to the failed federal policy of unrestricted spending and limitless debt. The U.S. debt is over $18 trillion and climbing. That's over $56,000 for every man, woman, and child in Texas. What's worse are the unfunded liabilities, which are currently at over $123 trillion, creating a debt burden of almost $400,000 for every Texan. The longer we wait, the higher the number goes. And we all know it's not going to turn around. That debt number isn't going to get smaller in our lifetime. And also, I think we should know that it's not your debt. You didn't agree to this. So you don't owe $56,000 or $400,000 or so, some arbitrary number in between. You don't owe it because you didn't put your name on the line. You didn't sign the loan agreement. You didn't authorize the money being printed out at the Federal Reserve. That didn't happen. You didn't do it. So don't feel like you owe that money. The government guys certainly aren't going to feel obligated to pay it off.
They're not going to pay it.
No. They're going to walk from that and go, oh, well, we got a new dollar.
They just managed the debt. The dollar is...
Forget it.
The dollar is debted into, is borrowed into existence.
Yeah, you think any of those guys will take an inkling of responsibility? No.
No way.
They'll all point the finger.
Moving on with their list. Now, this, they have actually two entries here that don't have any accompanying text. So they just have the header and no description. So I feel like the page is incomplete. Maybe they haven't finished the website. They do give you the header, though. So the next two are a secure border and a sane immigration policy. Now, that can mean a lot of different things. Secure border certainly means more, you know, government on the border. I don't support that. But that is going to be a motivating factor for some people to support secession because they feel like the government, the federal government, isn't doing a good enough job of keeping people out of their little club.
Yeah, a lot of people want to see a border fence go up and, you know, all the expense that would go with the fence and the guards to guard the fence and all the vehicles to patrol the fence and everything. I can understand why people in Texas would be worried about this.
Well, and let them pay for it if that's what they want.
Yeah, fine by me. You know, pay, because it's never going to stop. You know, why don't we hire some cheap illegal immigrants to keep the border secure?
It's a great solution.
Yeah, just, I mean, you can get them from across the border. Matter of fact, you don't even have to bring them to the United States. You just pay everybody, oh, I don't know, $2 an hour to keep people from coming across the border. Oh, you say they're going to get paid off by somebody for money? Well, that's what's happening to the border guards now, you fool.
It's true, Mark, that you're saying it's never going to stop. But I think that if you did have Texas secede, and then they got all crazy with border security and went ahead and built a crazy wall with a moat and an underground electrified fence or whatever the heck they
would need. Crocodiles.
With sharks with lasers.
Yeah. And don't forget helicopters as well. You know, you got to keep the helicopters flying. That's expensive. So
drones. We need some drones.
Yeah. If they actually did that and then they locked down all the other borders, because they then have to lock down the entirety of Texas, right? Because you wouldn't be able to just get away with locking the southern border down. You'd have to lock down the whole state. That's a long border for that big old state, right? So let's say they lock it all down. Well, it may actually reduce the immigration into Texas, because if it's easier to get into Arizona and New Mexico and California, then why wouldn't you go to those places? I mean, if you're coming from Mexico and you can go into the other states where there's not an insane border situation and they're not hunting people down, trying to, you know, arrest them at their jobs, as we're seeing the federal government do here and there today in the United States. If it's easier to live in those other states, why the hell would they go to Texas? See where I'm coming from?
I get it, but I think Texas has got a strong competition from how bad it can be in Arizona, especially specifically around Phoenix.
I was presuming that Texas would be the worst of all of them, right? If it's a penitentiary, you know, kind of state, why would you want to go in there?
Yeah, it's well known by economists and rulers that more people, a constant influx of people is good for the economy. But xenophobia has been used by rulers for a very long time because scared people, angry people love their government.
They'll turn to it for everything.
People who are peaceful and happy, they don't love their government nearly as much. So, you know, those that rule you, ladies and gentlemen, what they do is they pit you against these poor, illegal immigrants that all they want to do is be able to feed their families. And they make you angry at them, and then they support the corporations that benefit from this secondary level, the second-class individual. You know, these corporations, it's businesses that are employing them. The illegal immigrants are coming here because they're making money. Somebody's giving them a paycheck. So that's what it all comes down to. Don't hate on them.
So I might disagree with them on that reason for secession, but at the same time, I still support secession. I think we do need to have more experimentation in these various different areas. Next one on their list here at thetnm.org. That's the T as in Texas, N as in nationalist, M as in movement.org. A sound monetary policy based on real value. Now, this is the other one they don't have any text for. So that one actually sounds pretty good, right? To have a maybe a silver or gold-backed currency?
I feel
currency?
Like the Liberty Dollar put a bunch of work into Texas way back in the day. Don't you remember they were trying to develop a Texas dollar?
I don't recall that. That doesn't mean it didn't happen.
Yeah, I thought they were trying to. So this idea has been around for a long time for them to develop their own silver.
I hope they do.
Currency.
I think it's a great idea.
That's
they could do it right now if they wanted to. But obviously, you know, Bitcoin is sort of the new thing on the scene, and it's doing great. So maybe they wouldn't even need to have a Texas currency. Maybe they could just let the market decide what would happen there.
Right.
But still, good reason to secede.
Yeah, you don't need to tell me whether I can do business in silver or Bitcoins or gold or, I don't know, farm fresh eggs.
But yeah, getting away from the Federal Reserve currency, that's a fine reason to secede from the U.S. Next one on the list, Texas and the United States are on divergent political, cultural, and economic paths. Texans are known for a different way of life than the other 49 states. It's usually the cause of fist shaking in both directions when it comes to politics, as Texans prefer a more limited government, like a legislature that's only scheduled to meet every 2 years. Economically, Texans prefer a lighter regulatory burden on business, fostering entrepreneurship and allowing for the creation of more jobs and a higher standard of living. And when it comes to culture, Texans have been recognized since their inception, or Texans have been recognized since their inception, I think it means the state's inception, as a celebrating, boasting, and talking in a distinct manner. The pride in the nation of Texas is second to none. The music scene carries a distinct difference from the U.S. in almost every genre, and when it comes to food, well, put on your jalapeno eating boots, because it's going to get spicy.
This is what they got? We eat jalapenos, so we should secede. Well, I'm sorry, Ian.
It's good reasons.
Poorly, yeah, no, yuck, dumb.
Well, it wasn't the best description for the header, which, you know, is a better header, that they're on a divergent political, cultural, and economic path. They're
that
saying
much
we're
is
different
absolutely
from the U.S.
true. And this is something that I find really interesting. Now, imagine for a second, ladies and gentlemen of Merca, we've got these huge political parties, the Democrats and the Republicans, and they're constantly fighting with each other. They're warring with each other. They're trying to get their agenda over the others. But mostly what you see is nothing happening because it's like a tug of war. I'd like to posit a solution. I'm not going to say it's a solution. I'd like to posit a solution, get your opinion. The number is 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years. Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you got to keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. If you are against secession, you're certainly welcome to join us because I think the idea is a fine idea. And Mark, even though you don't think it's realistic, you still support the idea, right? Like if Texas were to have a vote on this, you'd be rooting for it, wouldn't you?
Well, I would be, like, in my heart, I would be rooting for it.
You wouldn't speak that you support them?
I'm also interested in people being well taken care of, and we have this thing called Social Security.
That doesn't take care of people well.
It's better than nothing.
Mark, that's a false choice. It's not that you would have nothing in the absence of the U.S. government. What you would have would be millions of people in Texas, I think like 26 million of them in that case, millions of people who would be able to keep the money that they earn. Which means that they would be able to contribute directly towards the care of the people who need it. They don't. You don't need the federal government to take a bunch of money from you, lob a bunch off the top of what they take, and then hand you a pittance back in order to take care of people. People can take care of each other directly, and you don't need bureaucrats in D.C. to facilitate it. Yes, I know people have already paid into that system and everything, but if you end the relationship with the federal government today, that means more money in your pocket immediately tomorrow. And that would make enough of a difference because when each individual gets to spend the money that they earn, they allocate it more accurately. When you get to decide to whom to donate the money that you've earned, which charity, for instance, or which individual is it that needs your help, then that's the market making better choices overall, thousands or millions of better choices than some panel of bureaucrats on high determining where to spend people's money that they've stolen from them. I mean, it just makes more sense.
I'm with you when it comes to charity being fine to take care of people who actually need it. But let me ask you this. Okay, you're no longer a, how old are you? 35?
I'm 34.
Okay, you're no longer a 34-year-old ideological talk show host. You're a 70-year-old individual who worked their whole life in a labor-oriented job. You have very little in savings, and the only thing you've been getting is that little tiny Social Security check of like $1,600 a month. I don't know everything about Social Security. I think that's the maximum. I don't expect to get it. So $1,600 a month you're getting right now. Now, would you rather, I'm asking you a question, would you rather rely on the system that you paid into that is owed to you, or would you rather rely on charity that somebody might give you some amount that would be greater or less simply because you lost the Social Security check because your state decided to secede from the union?
I'd rather go with secession because then my grandkids and my kids would be set free from this oppressive system, and they would be much more likely to take care of me in that state.
The smart thing to do would be to sell whatever house you have or whatever.
And move to California?
And move to Oklahoma, you know, or whatever as quickly mm-hmm. as you can to some other state so that you can continue getting your benefits, and hopefully you will in that circumstance. Now, consider Texas has a lot of oil. It's going to be a big loss for the United States government. I think it would be good for a small area to do something like that, something the size of New Hampshire, less so for a large area. Texas really is basically it's a country. It should have been its own country.
It's not too late.
Yeah, it is.
Well, you're very defeatist, Mark.
I'm not defeatist. I'm realistic.
Yeah, you are. 855-450-FREE. You got to have big dreams. And we've got one more thing here on the list of why Texans say they want to secede. We'll continue with that here in a moment, but I also want to let you know about ProXPN. If you are online at all, whether it's your smartphone, your tablet, your laptop, your desktop computer, you can get ProXPN. ProXPN is available for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. You go to proxpn.com/FTL, and you can get started right now with their free account. Give it a try. What they do is they encrypt your internet connection so your own internet service provider will no longer know what you're doing online, and criminals trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets will also be flummoxed. You go to proxpn.com/FTL, get started there, and then when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, you can use code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and then 50 as in 50% off of the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account. With that code, FTL50 breaks the price down to around $5 per month, and that's good for the lifetime of the account. So when you're ready to renew for your second year, you still get the same awesome discount. And with that premium account, you'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. So drop on into ProXPN at proxpn.com/FTL and try it out. You get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. Promo code is FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Daniel's in Oakland, California. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Tarrin, and Mark.
Yeah, I've got a couple points about what Mark was saying about Social Security.
Yes, sir.
Whatnot. Two, the fact that someone could work their entire life and get to age 65, as you say, not have very much savings. That's totally just a consequence of the monetary system.
Yeah.
And the fact that the guy who gets the money last gets the shaft.
Yep.
And you can fiddle around the edges with this or that pension program. That's not going away as long as you have the same monetary system.
Right. The fiat currency is, where the Federal Reserve creates money out of nothing. Yes.
Exactly. If you're at the end of the line, you're getting the shaft. The other point is that people don't pay into Social Security. They get robbed and they're told a story. Now, some people accept that as a loss and go about their business. Other people believe the story because I don't know why.
Well,
the fact is, if you look at all the money you pay in and then all the money you're going to get out, some people come out ahead. But long term, if you do the math, you know, you're going to get the shaft.
Yeah, rich females that come out ahead in Social Security?
If you take people on the aggregate, the payout in Social Security, people get about between 0 and 1% on their money. So it's a terrible investment anyway. But
yeah,
I mean, it's important to point out that poor people don't live as long as rich people. Men don't live as long as women, and black people and other ethnicities don't live as long as white people. So essentially you have three poor black men working to keep one rich white woman in her Social Security check.
No one would ever structure a private pension that way. And that just goes to show that it's a scam, because if you were to try to set something up like that in the real world, people would be like, I'm not going along with this.
Yeah. The problem is that it looks like the truth up to this point, right? Like, you're going to get some sort of subsistence level check if, you know, in retirement, and people expect that to happen. I think you will continue to get a check as long as the United States government exists.
It's not going to buy anything.
But, well, no, yeah, that's the thing. It'll buy your dog food for the month.
Right.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. The people who expect to live off of that, what they need to do is pull their heads out of their butts, start acting like grown-ups, and realize that they got robbed. And that's sort of the price of doing business, you know, living in America.
Have you ever watched one of the
– I'm owed this money back.
Have you ever watched one of the Mark Dice videos?
I've seen a few of them. Yeah,
where he goes around and asks people how many stars there are on the flag. what the name of the vice president is, what country the United States fought a revolutionary war against. I'm sorry. America is full of ignoramuses. They give the vote to a bunch of people, and this will be true in Texas when it's if it secedes too.
There are consequences to being stupid.
There certainly are.
That's true, but that's why we need to get informed people together here in New Hampshire so we can actually have a chance at this. Thanks, Daniel, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. Because I agree with where he's coming from. He's right. People do need to wake up to the fact that Social Security, especially if you're in a millennial or Generation X, is certainly not going to look like it does today. It's going to be more difficult to get if it even exists at all. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting GoBerkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Key Score, Boundless Informant. Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state. Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betray their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the OffNow project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
back here now on Free Talk Live. We got time for you if you want to join us at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's Texas Secession Night here on Free Talk Live.
Apparently.
That's what we ended up talking about. It really wasn't my intention, but that's just how the show goes. You know, talk about different stuff. And you can influence that by calling in 855-450-FREE. Something else you need to know about. Tarrin's got himself a YouTube channel.
That's true.
It's LCL Reports. You can just search for Tarrin Lupo, though.
Yeah.
And you posted a video about some young entrepreneurs. It's been linked to on our Facebook and Twitter, so you can go and see it there or just go and search Tarrin. Is it Tarrin P. Lupo?
No, it's TarrinLupo.com.
Just Tarrin Lupo.
And,
oh, really? Will that take you right to the...
That should. If not, it's being... I'm moving my server tonight, so there might be some issues with that. Just look for my YouTube. Yeah, because it's going through
website
some...
Website coming soon.
Yeah, it's going through some stuff at the moment. But the point is, it was a story about little kids who decided they wanted to make money by selling vegetables. It's a cute little story. It's real short, but it's
about... It's from here in the area, right?
Yeah,
New Hampshire?
It's right... most of the stories I'm doing now are going to be New Hampshire-based.
Cool.
So this one spotlights... Because I've seen things like 4-H, but I've never seen kids who actually plan out... grow their own garden. It's a girls' club. So these are all like little girls between like 7 and 10. And they kind of figure out what they're going to grow. And then they go to the market and they actually sell it themselves.
They have these farmers' markets all over the place up here. The local vore is a very big thing. The whole eating food that is grown locally.
That's all I do is, I mean, I go, just my little town of Peterborough has two markets that I go to, and I buy anything green at the markets. Like, all my vegetables are market-based, because I think it's important to support those, and it's really not that much more expensive than the grocery store.
You moved to the right place. I mean, there was a chart that came out, or one of those infographs that showed the different states.
Mm-hmm.
I think, I don't remember which order it was, but New Hampshire, Maine, Vermont.
I think New Hampshire was third.
New Hampshire might have been third on that list, was like one of the top three most local vore states of all 50 U.S. states.
The interesting thing about that local vore chart is it was close between Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont, and then everybody else was in the dust.
Really?
Right? Like all these people that say, you know what we want? We want food freedom! Right? And they say they're going to move out someplace where food is grown well. You know what? Where it's easy to grow food in Iowa... People have their own food. They don't need to buy it from you. If you want to sell food to people, you need to go where they buy the food. The places to do that are Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont.
Well, it's hard as hell to grow food in New Hampshire sometimes.
It is not that hard to grow food in New Hampshire.
Yeah, in the summer, it's been, you know, I mean, stuff's blowing up all over the place.
I've heard there's a lot of rocks.
Yes, there are a lot of rocks.
What do you do, plant on top of it?
What do you think the freaking pilgrims grew their food in?
I don't know.
What do you think the rocks showed up since the 1750s?
Well, you ever notice that everybody has rock fences here?
Yeah.
That's what it's from. Is they cleared the rocks out of the field and made fences out of them.
You don't know that?
I'll be damned.
I know. I'm a Southerner.
Where did the rocks come from, Ian?
Well, I didn't know why. I just figured they wanted to build a fence. I didn't know that was the reason
that they were
clearing
the fields and they used them.
They were digging they were using their horse or their son to pull a plow, and then they go plink, pull a rock up. They pick the rock up, they put it in a cart, they take them all at the end of the day, and they put them in a wall to differentiate their property from somebody
else's
property.
I just thought they were building the walls because they wanted to build the walls. I didn't know it had something to do with farming.
They had to do something with the rocks.
The original clearing of the land.
It has less to do with differentiating their property line and more to do with just
getting
them
with these things?
The farthest they could possibly get them from the place where they want to grow food.
I see.
And
so
I will say,
property line.
That is one of the coolest things because I didn't even know that about New Hampshire. I drove up and I was like, why do everybody have these cool walls?
Yeah.
I mean, they're everywhere. And
they
I was
cool
like, I can't even imagine what that kind of stonework would cost if you didn't have rocks on your property.
Or how much time it would take to move all those rocks around?
And
oh,
then
yes.
think of, I mean, if you ever sat
course,
and
to do?
Thought about... who lived here before you and all the stuff they did to this. Like, you have a house. Who actually built it? What was involved in
this
building
this? Was built
this
in the 1890s.
And who's lived here? What kind of families
Balloon
have been
construction.
Through here?
It'll go up like a match.
Yeah, probably.
ladies and gentlemen, Google balloon construction.
Well, I don't
but
know
just
what that
looking
means.
At
the walls are the floors are hung. Basically, they don't have. I'm bad at explaining this because I don't have the good terminology. There's a straight shot up the wall from the first floor to the second floor that the fire can shoot up very quickly. So the fire gets into the wall and it consumes the house like a match head.
Oh, that's nice.
And there goes the firefighter having to bring that in.
Yeah,
had to take that. But you know, if you just think about, I was sitting here thinking. how many people did it take and how long to build one of these walls? Like, what's the story behind these people? And it's just something we take for granted. We drive by and we see hundreds of these things.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, thank goodness for those people that live the hard life.
Yeah,
here,
because I mean, if you really think about that. That was hardcore, man.
Right.
Well, one of the difficulties is sort of insulating some place like this. Getting stuff into the walls to insulate an old building. But I built a new house. It was built, I think, in 2008. Mm-hmm. I can't remember exactly, but I wouldn't recommend that crap to anyone.
Because you went over cost.
Way over. Here's my recommendation to somebody who's thinking about building a house. Lots of people have this dream. First step: go to your bank and withdraw $10,000. Take it, put it in your front yard, spray it down with lighter fluid, and set it on fire. You will have then
the
slightest inkling of what it might be like to build your own house.
Oh, you're just selling me, Mark. You're
selling
me.
Make sure you do this in front of your wife without asking her permission, because that will give you some idea of what the fights and complaints that you will be experiencing.
Wise words.
It's a terrible idea to build. Buy somebody else's problem.
Before I forget... Ian, you did post the story on your Facebook page, right? If they go to the Free Talk Live Facebook.
It's on the Free Talk Live Facebook.
Yeah, please give that a share. And
your video, Taryn's video about the young entrepreneur selling their locally grown produce.
It's a cute story. It's short.
And it's just a club. It's a club they're in?
Yeah, it's a girls' gardening club. I didn't even know these things existed. And it's the little girls that sell
Welcome
and make
to New
money.
Hampshire,
and
right?
Yeah, they're excited because I was thinking of things like 4-H that we have where you just kind of do that stuff for free. I don't remember them going and making money. And it's a whole different game.
Secession for Texas, the final point. Mark asked the question. I'm just trying to answer it. Why are some Texans wanting to secede? Well, their final point is independence means an end to the siphoning of Texans' hard-earned money by D.C. bureaucrats. Well, contrary to the fuzzy math often applied by article contributors outside of Texas when speaking about the financial dependency of the federal government, there's only one direction that net receipts flow between Texas and D.C. Add up all the money contributed to the feds by Texas governments, municipalities, residents, and businesses, and subtract the money that Texas is lucky enough to get back from D.C., including all forms of federal programs, grants, funds, and Texan share of all federal-level spending like the defense, parks, foreign aid, EPA, FCC, USDA, etc. You'll find out that while other states get more back than they pay in, Texas has been a net contributor for the past couple of decades, receiving as little back as 83 cents on the dollar. And that's not even adjusting for the inflation caused by the Federal Reserve fiat currency system by the time it makes its way back to Texas.
Okay, so we were talking about that they were wondering if they were a donor state, and they definitely
and they
are. 83%.
And that's another good
point.
A big
one.
For people that are in these donor states, when you leave the union, all that money stays in your state, which is more money that you can then send to people who are expecting a Social Security check. They could create a program for everybody that was on Social Security to say, hey, we can give you a check. Here, people can donate now to this program.
Well, that's really awesome for the people in Texas. They can pay the same amount of taxes they were paying before, but now they have lots of travel restrictions when they want to leave their state.
No, it wouldn't be the same amount of taxes, Mark. It would
you
be much less.
You just said it was
the
donor
because-
state. And you were going to use that extra money to pay off the people's Social Security. There's a lot of old people in Texas, my friend.
It would be less because you'd be able to keep the money in your own state. It would be allocated more effectively because people would be able to donate in the ways that they thought were best.
You're now king of Texas, and you're going to institute a new Social Security program?
No,
a new
I'm
bad
not.
Investment?
It was a voluntary program, Mark. It's a charity.
I think Carrie Brown actually
Don't you believe
this.
In charity?
I believe in charity. I don't believe in straw men. You don't know what the hell you're talking about. This isn't going
no, actually,
to work
yes,
the way
I
you're
do.
Proposing
If you
it.
Look at Dr. Mary Ruard, who's going to be speaking here in New Hampshire this weekend.
Yeah, I'm going
I
to
know.
See her.
I'll be emceeing the event.
Yeah, if
oh, you
look at if yes, you look at Dr. Mary Ruard's book, she explains that when people get to control their own money, it gets spent more efficiently. I touched on this earlier. She estimates that people would be 8 times more wealthy if they were just able to decide for themselves how to allocate their own money, which means these charities would be able to collect even more money than the federal
government.
That's
true, and it is true over time. People are going to want their Social Security checked next
it'd be,
month.
It'd be true quickly, actually, because, you know, the market responds quickly to demand. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Mark, your fears are not a reason to stay with the federal
it's
government.
Not a fear.
There's more coming up.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it?
If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We've got time for you. If you want to join us here, whether you want to talk secession or rubber sex objects hanging from the power lines all over Portland, apparently. We're going to get into that story here coming up. With you tonight, it's Ian.
Tarrin P. Lupo.
And King Mark the First.
Let's tell you a little bit about Purse. I am wearing, if you're watching the webcam, you can see me here. I'm wearing my new pair of headphones that I just got, Sony MDR V6. Nice kind of pro studio headphones.
You've always liked those. Yeah, I'm...
I like the ones you're wearing, but they don't make those anymore.
They don't?
Yep. So if you want to get a new pair of headphones, these are the ones.
No, my ears can't handle those. They squish my ears.
No, they don't squish mine. They're actually doing pretty well. But
I know.
They're
never had a problem
with
them.
Nice pair. And I got big ears, Mark, so I don't know what you're talking about. But I got these at 29%.
Yeah. I don't know what my ears are like.
Percent. Hello, Mark. 29%
it's
off.
It's huge.
29% off the already low price of Amazon by paying with Bitcoin through purse.freetalklive.com. Now, from what I'm told, the first time you use Purse, they may only restrict you to 20%. I'm not real clear on whether that's happening or not, because, Mark, you did tell me that that there was a chance that maybe Free Talk Live listeners would not get that initial account restriction put on them, but
yep.
I'm still not real clear on that.
I'm not either.
So you may have a restriction to where you can only get up to 20% off, but once you do like one or two purchases, it opens up to 50% off. Now, odds are good you're probably not going to get anybody biting on the 50%, but it didn't take me more than a day to get somebody to order these headphones at 29% off the price through Purse. I'm paying with Bitcoin. That's how I get the discount. You can get 20% off anything you see on Amazon as well. It's easy to do. Just go to purse.freetalklive.com. Make sure you have some Bitcoin. If you don't have that yet, you can go to expresscoin.com to get them. But you go to purse.freetalklive.com to get signed up. And when you sign up through our link, you can then, from that point on, use the regular Purse URL. But sign up first through purse.freetalklive.com, and Free Talk Live get a very small portion of each of your purchases from that point forward. So do you want to save 20% or not? That's up to you. Purse.freetalklive.com. We go to Brent. He is on the line in Buffalo, New York. You're on Skype. Hello, Brent.
Hello, guys.
Welcome. Go ahead.
Just wanted to point out about the Social Security scam. The easy way to end it is to simply pay out to all the old folks that are collecting it the $5 or $5,000 that they put into it over the years and call it even.
Who is going to pay that out? I mean, the federal government certainly isn't going to.
They can't. They spend it.
Right, because, yeah, it's gone. I mean, the money that comes from Social Security is being taken right now from young people, which is why I think secession would work because, you know, people still have money and they could donate it.
Wait. So you're saying they don't have any savings for Social Security?
Oh, you knew that.
Right, yeah. Right.
Well, I think Harry Brown brought up a point that you could sell off all the government lands and just stroke a one-time check to all these people and buy them out. You know,
that would be if the federal government was to be ending Social Security, right? That would.
Well, no, I meant like if Texas seceded, they could take the federal government land.
Ooh, now
and
that's
sell
an interesting idea.
And yeah, pay it good. Out. To all those people so they could take the checks and invest it wherever they want.
See, now that's the kind of innovative thinking that we need here.
Kind of thing that'll start a war.
That makes secession possible, right?
It was South Carolina trying to take over some federal property that caused the first war.
Boy, you think you can secede and just let the feds have their property?
Yeah,
that's not going to work.
I like how the feds didn't take the property away from the states. You know, I mean, the states had it first.
Wrong. Sorry, Brett, go ahead.
Mark is wrong there.
Okay, go
South
ahead.
Carolina was not trying to take over property. They were simply trying to use their harbor.
Yeah, they were blocked off, but they fired on a federal fort with the intention of taking
allegedly.
It, right? Allegedly.
It was either fire on the federal fort or try and sail by it and get fired upon.
Yeah, I got that the federal government had bottled up their harbor, but it's not like they were going to go anywhere. I mean, you know, when somebody with a bigger stick is goading you to hit them with the stick, you don't hit them with the stick.
Well, what if the feds fired first and it's, you know, just a false flag?
I don't care, man. I can tell you who the losers were. History is written by winners.
Brent, anything else you want to share tonight? Good call.
Robert E. Lee lost that war when he decided to make that charge.
I was asking Brent, Mark. Brent, go ahead.
Only that Mark is wrong.
Yes, what's new?
Robert E. Lee
lost
that war when he decided to make that charge in Gettysburg. And Pickett's charge guaranteed it.
So shield your kids' eyes, all you prudish parents, if you're living in Portland. According to Gawker, a specter is haunting Portland. The specter of... I shouldn't say the word. I mean, I've had programmed... I mean, it's not officially banned, but I'm not going to say the D word here because some program directors could be upset. By that. According to Reuters, hundreds of phallic sex toys, I think we can say that, have recently started appearing on Rip City power lines, prompting numerous complaints to the city and several delightful Twitter posts. Hundreds of phallic sex toys.
That's a very expensive thing to do.
Yeah, because these things aren't cheap, right?
No, I can understand throwing old tennis shoes up, but I mean, basically, you have these foam phallic toys that are tied like nunchucks, thrown up all over power lines.
Yeah, that's right. It's gonna get
expensive.
But fear not, penally menaced Portlanders, because officials say the synthetic D word poses no immediate threat. From Reuters, a spokesman for the public utility Portland General Electric said he didn't believe the rubber products posed a fire hazard. Still, area power companies would prefer that you didn't use their lines as ad hoc nunchub hangers. That's cute, nunchubs. I've never heard that.
Nor have I.
And they're nunchubs now because of the string tying them together,
yes,
right?
Of course.
The temptation may be there for tittering, a Pacific Power spokesperson told the Oregonian, but we want to keep the lines as safe as possible. Now, Tarrin, right. You had some history here.
Do you guys know how this started?
No.
When people throw tennis shoes up on power
I never understood it. I just thought it was drunk kids or something like that. Because you only see in Keene, you'll see it, but you only see it in the college neighborhood. So I just figured some drunk kid throwing them up there.
All right. So kind of in the ghettos or in the crowded cities, you'd have these power lines that, you know, there's not a lot of room to park. So most of the parking you did was under these lines. And pigeons would sit above there and poop all over your
car.
Yeah,
they would.
So they started throwing these shoes up to scare off the pigeons. They're supposed to blow around the wind and keep pigeons off. But what happened is it ended up that nobody understood why that was happening, and it just became a big cultural thing to just throw your shoes
throw
up
there.
And then it just took on a life of its own.
But wait, did it actually work to keep the pigeons away?
Nobody knows. I assume that it must have at one point because, you know, someone thought it to do it, and then it just took off, and it became a cool thing to do to get rid of your old shoes.
Wow, I never knew that. Mark, did you know that about that?
No, it's one thing I did
know.
Not know.
That's why you bring me on for this good knowledge.
Thank you,
Tarrin. That
was really valuable.
This and the Love Boat. I know a lot about the Love Boat.
Were you a big fan of that?
I do love it.
It's exciting and new.
Yeah, did you
know
how many episodes they had? It was crazy. I mean,
no.
They were on for almost like 10 years.
I don't know if I've ever seen it, believe it or not. I think that was daytime television, right? Love Boat?
Well, what happened is, you know, I grew up in
the 80s.
No, it
wasn't daytime. It was
primetime?
Primetime.
It was primetime, yeah.
Okay.
But what happened in the 80s is it got picked up in reruns and it was on, like, daytime television.
Anyway, it's a great show. That's why.
And it was trashed by the critics, but everybody loved
it. Really?
Everybody loved it. Yeah, they called it Love American Style on a Boat.
What the hell do the critics know? You know, Brian,
don't know anything.
Brian Sovereign wrote a great review of the new Terminator movie over on his website.
Right.
And I don't know if it's at Sovereign Tech or the Zog blog. Zog blog. He loved it, and the critics hated it. If you go to Rotten Tomatoes, it got like a 27%, which that's not very good. But the critics, you know, they're not fans, right? A critic isn't necessarily a fan of the Terminator series, so they're not going to appreciate the things that are being done in the movie. They're looking for some kind of Oscar performance or whatever, you know, fancy Hollywood things that they're looking for, right? Like, you know, if you're a fan of Terminator, you'd enjoy this movie,
right,
in my opinion. And Brian did a great job of really outlining why the movie was excellent. But, you know, you can't go by what the critics are saying.
You know what's a fun thing to do if you have a 20 minutes to kill is go look up old Siskel and Ebert reviews from the 80s, mm-hmm, like the Ghostbuster reviews up there, Pulp Fiction,
you
know, like all these old movies. And they are awesome. The old reviews, the from
Meaning
Siskel
they
and
didn't like them, or they did.
They did, but they. It's funny because like they're reviewing Star Wars, and they don't think it's going to be a big deal. You know, like,
what do they
like
know?
That.
I mean, how
yeah,
would they
it was
know?
Great. It was
That's
great.
Funny.
Yeah,
that
go
is
look
cool.
Them up.
They both passed away.
No,
didn't
just
they?
The one. The one died of the jaw cancer. He had his lower jaw removed. The heavier one, Ebert, right?
I thought Siskel died first. I thought Siskel died and then Ebert died.
There's still one left. He's still writing reviews.
To me, that's popular culture, and I don't know.
Yeah, well, that's why you have me on. There you go.
You seen any good movies, Tarrin?
I have not seen anything. Right now, I'm rewatching Battlestar Galactica.
Ant-Man, end of the week. I'm up.
Ant-Man.
It's going to be awesome.
You are incorrect, Tarrin. He died in 1999.
He
Gene Siskel. It was Roger Ebert who lived longer than Siskel.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. They're both dead. You're right.
They're both dead
I am
now.
Wrong.
Yeah.
I'm totally wrong on this.
But there you go.
I removed my card.
All right. Thanks for coming, Tarrin.
Pop culture card.
Check
I
him out
it.
When his website's back, which hopefully will be soon, at TarrinLupo.com.
Yep. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem, man. And then look for him on YouTube. You can do that right now because his channel's still up there. All right, so we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, at freetalklive.com.
You can't win if you don't enter, and you actually can improve your chances of winning a prize drawing if you wrinkle up your entry blank. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com, and I speak from experience. Why this works? If they'll be spinning the drum before drawing, your entry blank will move around more than, and not adhere to, other perfectly flat entry blanks. And if they don't spin the drum and merely reach into a box full of other perfectly flat entry blanks, many of which are sticking together, yours will feel different to the person reaching in. When you win, act surprised. And if you're looking for work, this is a metaphor. For more tips on sticking out in a world where just too much blends into the blah, 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 hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 15th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.30 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,155 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $295. Antiwar.com reports remnants of the former Yemeni government loyal to Abd Rabu Mansour Hadi. The forces, allied with Saudi Arabia, yesterday launched a surprise attack on the international airport in the southern port city of Aden, seizing it and several nearby districts. The Shiite Houthis, who had been in control of the airport, insisted they withdrew from the city after cleansing it of Al-Qaeda forces. There has been fighting in the city for months throughout the Saudi-led war against the Houthis. The Hadi forces have made considerable gains against the Houthis in recent days after agreeing to a ceasefire which was supposed to begin Friday night and theoretically should still be in place. Throughout the ceasefire, the Saudis have continued to attack and the Hadi forces have taken advantage to seize territory. Hadi officials cheering the retaking of parts of Aden say they believe they'll have the whole city under their control in the coming days. Whether that will lead to new humanitarian aid shipments to the city or simply more Saudi military aid drops into the area remains to be seen. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. UPI reports cash-strapped Puerto Rico found little support among creditors for restructuring its $72 billion debt, some of which must be repaid in July. Representatives of the island Commonwealth met Monday in New York with over 300 representatives of investment firms, hedge funds, and insurance companies, but offered little information. It was the first meeting of government officials and creditors since Governor Alejandro Garcia Padilla acknowledged in June that Puerto Rico could not meet deadlines for debt payments on municipal bonds sold in the past decade. Melba Acosta of Puerto Rico's Government Development Bank told the creditors that they would have to accept adjusted terms of repayment, although she offered no details. Her comments followed recommendations 2 weeks ago by former International Monetary Fund officials who suggested bonds should be replaced with new bonds offering later maturities and reduced debt payments. She said, "I ask for your patience while we develop a credible plan." The Commonwealth has a history of balancing its budgets by borrowing, and its economy has declined since 2006. In the past 10 years, its population has declined by 7% as residents of the island sought employment opportunities in the continental United States. Among its debts are a $93.7 million payment due July 15th and another $140 million payment due on August 1st.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports Missouri on Tuesday put to death a man convicted of murdering a 19-year-old woman he encountered in a traffic accident in 2001 in the first execution in the United States since the Supreme Court upheld the use of lethal injection drugs. David Zink was pronounced dead at 7:41 p.m. Central Daylight Time after receiving a fatal dose of drugs in a state prison. The U.S. Supreme Court ruled on June 29th that a lethal injection drug used by Oklahoma, midazolam, did not violate the U.S. Constitution's ban on cruel and unusual punishment. The High Court did not directly address the constitutionality of the death penalty in the United States, but provoked a caustic debate among the justices. The Supreme Court on Tuesday denied several appeals from Zink's lawyers to halt the execution, including claims that Missouri officials would be violating federal laws by using pentobarbital obtained from a compounding pharmacy. Zink had been named the plaintiff in a lawsuit brought by a group of Missouri death row inmates who alleged the state's lethal injection protocol is unconstitutional and creates a substantial risk of severe pain. The allegations are part of a national debate about the use of compounding drugs in U.S. executions amid a shortage of traditionally used pharmaceuticals. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. A report by Stanford University researchers released Thursday found that Americans spend 90% of their waking hours staring at glowing rectangles. Researchers identified more than 30 varieties of iridescent rectangles, ranging from personal and work rectangles to rectangles that heat food and those that can fit right in one's pocket.
From the moment Americans wake up, they are captivated by these bright, pulsing rectangles. In fact, if you look at the data, it's hard to find a single minute when the public isn't captivated by these. Excuse me. I'm sorry, where were we?
In local news, a runover squirrel is remembered as frantic and indecisive. And in other news, a trail of rose petals leads a wife to a sink full of dishes. Prince Fielder reports to spring training exactly the right amount overweight, and a local yard sale reeks of divorce. If you don't hear the sound of my voice the same time next week, alert my family and then visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
Welcome to Cop Block Radio. We're live. It's Wednesday, July 15th, 2015. I am Derek J, broadcasting from Thien, New Hampshire. And across the internet, we've got Dio.
Dio here, broadcasting from Ohio.
Meow. How you